Now we're live.
Hello and welcome to Haphazard Heroes, where we take part in a cooperative storytelling adventure set in the realm of Calderon using Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. This is the 92nd episode of this campaign, which is insane to say. We've been a lot of places. We've been a lot of random characters. You should check out the website, get all caught up. What's the website? Tarakas, what's the website? Lilith, what's the website?
Haphazardheroes.com.
Yes! Oh,
there it is.
Stole it. That's 2 points for the steal.
Dang it.
You level up. And that's how you get XP. Now you've learned how to play Dungeons & Dragons. So, check out our website. As they said, it's haphazardheroes.com. We got a whole bunch of old episodes there. One of the most important things on the website would be the last episode, which is right on the main splash page. And if you were on that main splash page checking out the last episode, what would they see? What would they have seen?
Gary,
stop yawning.
I can't help it.
Get it together.
What would they have seen on camera?
A big fight.
I guess. Yeah, what did happen last time? There was the...
We went to the Beast.
The first mission from Attack Team Bravo that...
The Beast got blown up. Well, that, not by us, technically. But
right, that's true.
Yeah, the other two.
There was an incursion into the Beast, a heavily guarded penitentiary in Brightguard, the capital city of Brightguard. The team was there to extract one Savine Wren.
We did that, too.
Who they did succeed at doing. In addition, they had run into Team Alpha, who was there to destroy the Beast and presumably everyone else that was in it. The teams parted ways, and there was a successful extraction, and behind them, as the John Cena music played, there was a slow-motion explosion as the group returned to the their captors in the Federation of Venkirk, bringing their Savine Wren target back with them, and had long rested, as we did off-screen.
Gary sacrificed himself.
Gary had sacrificed himself for the rest of the group, making sure that Gunk and Fago and Lilith and Tarakas all made it back safely. But one member of Team Bravo fell in duty just before his tenure was up.
Or did he?
Dun, dun, dun. Read up on Gary's fan fiction, alternate universe AU, where he did survive.
He ate everybody and
no, this kind of this kind of drama is great for D&D streams. Trust me, this is fantastic. The rest of the team, however, had made it back, rested, and we will catch up with them shortly. We also saw Kaz. Nobly working through his shifts day after day in these work camps, basically, having been approved for work duty.
He likes the schedule.
Likes the routine.
He likes the routine.
And is getting stronger. Honestly, his lats have never looked better. And
I mean, they looked pretty damn good before.
But he trusts that the rest of the group will come save him. We also caught up with one nerd Gloidnuts, who had... been taken in by his new, or rather his old, original crew under the captainship of Suresh, Zamila Suresh. The small goblin had feigned loyalty for most of the trip, or rather was loyal, and then had a change of heart towards the end of the trip, just outside the, after about a day or two's travel away from Emberhearth, the port city on Nadir, the southernmost continent in the realm. And after inspecting, quote unquote, the black powder barrels, Nerd slipped in some of these timers that were in his pocket and or in his pack, and set them to a certain period of time, ignited bobble gooks, and GTFO'd right out of there as, in his rearview mirror, the John Cena music started playing.
Bah, bah, da, bah.
And his jetpack, and he bobble gooked out into If anyone's cool, it's you, John Cena. Please be cool. The jetpack propelling the small goblin figure away from the explosion, and he sees parts of the ship go flying as this hole explodes and it begins to take on water. Nerd, however, is launched in a different trajectory, trying to get distance, more distance, till eventually we lost sight of Nerd as Babblegook's expended his arc into the water, into the freezing cold water near the South Pole, basically. And he saw just a few hundred feet away the glacial foothills of the mountains of Nadir. And I think we ended not too long after that. So let's catch up with the heroes today. So let's open with a similar scene to last time. Let's start with, actually, since now it's working, let's see if I can do what I wanted to do last time. Yeah. Okay. So.
Oh, we got music again.
It's supposed to be, nice. It's supposed to be in media res. So the opening scene is, again, similar to last time. There is an open, a side door on these airship dropships that you guys are familiar with now from the Federation. The blue glow of these discs on the bottom that keep you aloft. Tarakas, Lilith, the current leader who's got a little captain patch to somehow like in the globule like, center of like, is Faygo. And the other person in their team is
Dusty McGee.
What does Dusty McGee look like? Oh my god, is this the trope that I hope that it is?
Are we meeting on the ship?
Yeah. She's a fairy. Okay. She looks really fucking cute. She's got really dark skin and like pretty like blue hair. Gorgeous wings. Super cute little pixie nose. She just looks fucking adorable. She's about 3 feet tall. Maybe on a good day with the hair.
Right.
And then she is a Juggernaut barbarian.
What?
So she's about 3 feet tall.
Yeah.
And she packs punch. She does not have any weapons.
The fists. She's got a little tiny fist.
She's a wrestler. Like that's
okay.
What she does.
I
she
love
is
this.
A like a ring wrestler, but she doesn't actually win. She's paid to lose, so they call her nosedive.
Her and all the other people in this airship. Again, the doors are open. The wind is kind of whipping. All of you have goggles over your hair, over your eyes, and you've got in your ear. You've got your familiar. Connected sending stones that are kind of a closed circuit sending stone as well that kind of goes back to the Federation as well. You are flying in again at high speed. The scene is a little bit more like Apocalypse Now because you guys are cruising just over the hard deck, as it were, maybe a couple 20 feet above the ground. Rolling hills are what you see, but you also are taking in the vista of Eastern Zostra. Does anyone remember what is happening in Eastern Zostra right now? When you last were here. There was an elf war that was happening, a civil war that was happening. And more recently, as you left Deep Crest, there was a very large scale
fire?
Ship crashing
in Deep Crest. I'm sorry,
there was a very large
that there was gonna be a quiz.
That's true. right before Which one of these? That's the one that's working.
I know
okay.
The elves lost. I know that.
Right before you guys had been captured, or as you guys had been captured, rather, there was in the middle of a very large-scale invasion of on the part of the Federation invading Zostra, right?
Mm-hmm.
Starting with Deep Crest, there was all these Independence Day-style motherships that were hovering over these major cities, and all these airships dropping in. That is now in full scale. The countryside that you guys see is in the midst of a full-on war. This isn't the Elven Rebellion anymore. There are blue and black, right? The old
uniforms.
There's the familiar Federation colors that are clashing with the sparse the remnants of the Zostrian army that you guys hadn't ever really interacted with too closely. Thank God, while you guys were here. You guys have missed most of the Elven War stuff, but you guys are. I got a good one. This is basically the Jedi flying in Episode 3 over Genosha That's episode three, right?
Well,
when they're flying over the Separatist army, right, and they're like flying over the middle of a these dropships over the war has started, right? All the droids are out. It is a full scale conflict that you guys are flying over at the moment. Sites that are familiar to you, and remember, where you guys are flying over is
a lot of laser blasts.
Deep Crest. That's right. Yeah. Roger. But there is a lot of familiar sights as you guys fly over Lilith and Trock, so you guys can recognize what looks to be the smoking crater that was Deep Crest as you guys are flying over it at high speed, going north towards the Elven city. I can't remember its name, but it doesn't matter because it's long gone at this point. But you guys are racing towards the edge of the Haunted Forest. Where your current objective is at. The Haunted Forest, you guys, at least the Haphazard Heroes, had been at previously, where they had been in search of one of these AI that are worshipped as deities in this realm, the Moiray. This one being Apoptosa, one of the Moirays of Death. However, Tarakas's deity of knowledge had its the sum total of human knowledge had been stored here in these, essentially a server farm. So Tarakas knows that this is where he has stashed all of his eggs, basically. Well, at least the mainstay of his god is being kept here. And the objective for this group is to go there and destroy it.
But destroy what? The records?
Everything inside.
Everything inside.
Okay.
That is what you guys are racing towards to do. So, we catch up in media res as you guys are racing towards it at high speed. You guys are coming up on the edge of the Haunted Forest, and while this conflict is happening below you, you can see that there's a moment where you fly out over it, and suddenly there's an opening in the conflict, and it's just grassy knolls for a time. Seems people are even the fighting is giving this forest, the edge of this forest, space. And as you guys are flying over the open plains, suddenly you are skimming over treetops on the very edge of this haunted forest. And you guys get maybe 100, 200 feet into the forest, flying at top speeds. Bottom of the airship kind of flicking as the trees are hitting it, and then all of a sudden, in front of you, Lilith and Tarakas, you can recognize it, but something that looks like a large tree just rears up in front of the path of this thing slowly, just like a fish in a Star Wars story. Like there's always a bigger fish, really slow, really big, and there's a moment where you guys know that it's much faster than it looks, and the whole airship is rocked as the hand comes down, and this airship is spinning uncontrollably again, and it's almost like deja vu as Fago, you know that there's really not a good hit, not a good hit rate. The places they're sending these airships to, they almost never land safely, and
could have just stayed fucking higher.
And as this thing gets like swiped out of the sky, you guys are better equipped this time. Everyone has parachutes, goggles.
Good.
The side doors are open. Dying words from the pilot as you guys hear brace, 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 and bail out, bail, bail. You guys hear the co-pilot say, "You're right. I should have just flown higher." As these just kind of like porkinsing it into the side of the forest, into a large tree. You guys do all have these parachutes, though, so without any major roll, we're starting with you all very gently.
I have wings.
You have wings?
Yeah.
So, there's
I have wings too.
As the pilots choose to go down with the ship, thinking that, you know, there's only so many parachutes and this and that, whatever, not knowing that there's one extra, they crash and burn, they die, we never knew their names. Your name is Dusty.
Mm-hmm. Do we still have Gunk with us?
Flits down. Gunk's still with you guys. Gunk. Gunk's parachute doesn't work, and he just like flams us, okay. Hits all the way down on his face. But he's not moving.
Is that normal?
Oh, I mean, if he's dead, he's dead. Jesus. I mean, if he's dead, he's dead.
Okay.
Who am I playing? Oh my god, my personality.
I'll head over to Gunk.
Gunk!
Shake him a bit.
Yeah, shake him a little bit.
Are you okay? Are you waking up? Is this a test?
His really long nose just kind of like slopes out of the ground, and there's like an indentation of his face.
Yeah, it's fine.
He dusts off a little bit. And right about the time that you like say he's fine, Gunk's parachute goes off and kind of like covers everybody. We start the scene. Everyone's on the ground, covered in parachute. You guys have some free goggles in your inventory. They look like ski goggles, all in one piece. You guys are on the very edge of this haunted forest. It is very, unsettling. If you guys remember, this place is very quiet until it's not, right? You two know that this place is odd in that it's not many different individual plants, that this place is in fact a hive mind, hive plant, whatever you want to call that. And in fact, it's kind of one large plant that is the forest.
And they have bushes.
Has attention that can be kind of focused in different areas in the same way that one creature kind of can give attention in a certain place. Where you guys are dropped off is against the edge of the forest, but on your approach, when everyone was talking about how high or not high up, what would be safest, you guys were able to see the center of the forest, whereas there's allegedly a stone temple, the two of you have seen it, where you are all heading. So you have your general bearings, you know, general direction that you guys are supposed to be going. So you're not completely helpless, but you know that it is a dangerous place to be.
So I don't want to speak out of turn because I'm not in charge here, but so Lilith and I have been here before, Pago.
Sweet. Tell us where we're going.
Alright, well,
yeah, why are we here again?
Blow up something, kill something, I don't fucking know. Who got the directions?
I thought you did. You were telling us at the thing.
Oh yeah. Well, we go to the thing, the temple-y thing, and then we kill everything inside and blow it up.
Okay, well, I have issues with that. Because, well, it happens to be the place where I...
Don't have issues with it. They'll blow your brain up.
Well, anyway, what I really need to get to fast is that this whole forest can kind of sense us. In a sense, well, that doesn't help. It still tracks us. So I have a way of masking everyone if you'll let me do it.
How long does it take?
Might be a couple of seconds.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'm gonna go first.
Gunk trusts you. You're good. Friend. Says, friend, do spell.
Yeah, oh, well.
He kind of like makes a.
Yeah, you can be first, Gunk, and I'm gonna cast.
He closes his eyes really, really tight. Like he's getting a shot.
Arcanist magic aura on him and mask him to just appear undead.
Okay.
Okay, nothing really happened, obviously, but somehow the forest can sense this.
I don't feel any different.
Well, I haven't done it to you yet. My name's Tarakis. Hi.
Do you feel any different? He hasn't done it yet. He only did Gunk. How are we supposed to know, though, if he's not lying? I trust him.
Jesus Christ, you're paranoid.
Just ask him.
Well, I mean, we've never worked with her before.
I've never worked with you.
That's fair, too. I mean, yes. Anyway, so I'm going to continue doing this around the group, and I'm just going to start casting them on everybody. That's willing.
I'll hover above him. Just hover.
Yeah. Are you not willing to take it? Or are you
no, I'm willing to take it. I'm just hovering above him, watching him do it. Just hovering.
And hovering over everyone
she
else
hovers,
as they
she
get
hovers.
It.
I'm casting this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times.
Sure.
Okay.
So I'm going to burn my...
Do you have to do it 5 times?
Special...
Wasn't there another spell that you could just do a group?
It lasts for 24 hours. But it is a specific target that I have to cast it on for it to really work. It's not just a group.
But I'm using my channel divinity to do the other ones. Getting back a second spell level slot.
Okay. Tap him out. So you see Tarak is doing some big magic. And the those of you that are magically inclined can kind of not quite smell it, but you guys can sense that there is the aura, the vibe of everyone seems to change. And even there's an unsettling presence of the entire group as now the very essence that the group gives off is now not of living creatures, but of undead.
Yeah.
So the whole group now would appear undead to anybody who was using magic to search or scry or any other type of magical detection. I believe that's how that works, right?
I think so. I'm not sure about scrying, but otherwise, yes.
Yeah.
Cool.
The party is on the edges of the forest. You guys are marching towards, sounds like the
center,
edge of towards your destination. Everyone is fairly adept at adventuring at this point, at this level. You guys would get about 30 to maybe 30 minutes to an hour into the forest before you would notice something that's odd, at least different from your first time that you were here. And that is signs of human life. There are footprints, like sets of them, and then different, like old and new. So it looks like it's like a hunting path almost. It's a full-on like small trail. Not so much that it's trodden, that it's dirt, but there's a footpath essentially trodden down grass that is leading in multiple directions, kind of throughout the forest, but kind of largely in one common direction.
Toward the center.
Not towards the center. This is actually kind of a little bit deeper into the forest, but still on the edge. Still, definitely, if you would call it any part of the forest, it would still be on the outskirts.
Mm-hmm.
But it is in the forest. Who would have a really high perception? Lilith, probably you. You're probably the one doing this. How about a perception or investigation check from anybody that's interested enough to actually stop and look at these?
Perception? Do you want to?
Listen, tell me which one you're wanting to use.
Perception. 16.
The 16, you see enough of these that the imprint is of an unshoed foot. It looks just like there's toe prints in it. You can see it. Several large footprints and a couple small ones, like from a smaller creature. Look to be humanoid. Five toes.
We can see toes.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not wearing shoes.
Huh. Well, I guess it means they're barefoot. But I've never seen any signs of them out here.
Yeah, why would they be barefoot in the forest, though?
I mean, with everything going on, I'm guessing they're
maybe they
escaping.
Just like, you know, mud in the toes.
Maybe they're forest people.
Well, we never met him. Yeah, we never met him last time. There's absolutely nothing, like, alive in this
forest. The whole
forest? Well, from what we went through, and the things that tried to kill us, it didn't seem like something could survive in here.
Maybe they tamed the forest.
Well, I hope not, because I wasted a whole lot of magic for nothing.
Well, let's keep going towards the temple, though, because that's what we need to do.
Huh. Mm-hmm. Let's follow him.
What, the prince?
Yeah.
Or go towards the temple, because that's what we're supposed to do. If the prince are that direction, then fine.
Yeah.
But if they start veering, we still go towards the temple.
Yeah. Right. Yes.
Unless you wanted to push the button and blow up your head. Okay,
right.
Let's go.
Yep.
Every time that Fago brings it up, you know, there's a little bit of like a ringing in your ears, just kind of like a reassurance that people are like, yeah, we got you. Fago, before I forget, since you know what the mission parameters are and you are the team leader, you were probably also given the most important gear.
Oh, okay.
Of the equipment.
Explosives.
Yeah. Which are probably visible in you, I'm assuming.
In you.
Okay, as the gelatinous.
Can we reach inside?
Nope.
Okay.
Well, if I let you.
Okay.
And this is everyone has been an important lesson about consent.
Yes.
And gelatinous substances.
Yeah. Yes, yeah.
I'm curious.
So grabbing hearts. I mean, jeez.
As you are, does anyone else want to roll anything else? Is anyone else rolling, or is anyone doing any investigation at all? He's letting the 16. Is that what you're staying with?
I mean, she seems smart.
I'm going to trust these little. Actually, can I roll a survival check?
You're welcome to.
I want
to
see if.
I'm also vamping because I'm trying to remember what. You've made a couple people made recommendations what to do next, but I didn't hear any decisions get made, so let me know what's happening next.
I think the decision was to go towards the temple.
Temple?
Unless somebody tries to override.
Okay.
Yeah. Temple.
Mm-hmm. I just want to see if, like, throughout the prints that were in tracks that we're saying, if anybody appears to be injured, like, if there's any blood on the trail or
sure.
That kind of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. What do you want to roll for that? Investigation?
Survival?
Survival, yeah. Okay, I'm okay with that. Checking tracks.
Yeah. I rolled a nat one, but it's
like
a nine.
That's a nat one and nine. It's hard to tell much from these prints. But you do see there's some like little crumbly things next to them. Looks like that might be something. Might be some part of it. Looks like some like weird little crumbly like mushrooms or something that they may have stepped in. You're just sure this has to have something to do with it.
Oh, that was a really good ingredient they could have used. Dang it. Mm-hmm. Well, where did they drop it? Hey, you guys, look at this mushroom.
You pick it up and it goes,
Okay, maybe don't come. Yeah, I forgot about the wet forest and then I'll just drop it and just walk away.
Yeah, just kind of like makes a little sad balloon sound as he drops
in.
So you guys are walking towards the temple. Mm-hmm. Sounds like Turok is kind of being left behind. I'm looking at some of these, dropping some of these things. As you guys are walking closer to the temple, not too far away from where you guys are at, but still on your way towards the temple, there are what look to be large bags hanging from the trees.
Do these look familiar?
Almost like hornet's nests, but they are the size of... They're like humanoid size.
Bodies?
Well, I think it might be the pod.
Yeah. Can I fly up and touch one?
Yeah. Well, there's... Okay, so when we first came to this forest, we stopped at a village outside of it, and they said that the forest was bad and evil and dark. Well, there's like things in it. Anyway, they would sacrifice things like people that had died to the forest, and I don't know what kind of pod they put them in, but they put them in pods and trees, and then the next morning they were gone.
Okay.
Maybe those are the footprints.
Oh, no.
I'm getting ahead of myself. I do that sometimes.
But, like, to the temple?
Well, no, they would just put them in trees.
No, I'm saying... Going to the temple, so don't touch anything you shouldn't touch.
What?
Oh, well, okay. That's probably smart. I don't know what might pop out.
Fine.
Be cautious, but let's go.
You can see like the mushroom that he just like dropped and fizzled out. It seems like I don't know what else might pop out. Where he dropped it, there's like three more. They're like, they're like a little cluster.
Look what you
they're,
did.
They're blue and green. They look kind of like fluorescent.
Pretty.
As you guys are heading back towards the temple, before you guys even have a chance to get on your way, as these mushrooms are all popping up, there's one more thing that pops up just above about the same time, right above a log, and it is the head of a small human child.
Ew.
Oh,
and she says, "Hey!" And she pops up and it's attached to her little small body, and she's like, "Hey,
what are you doing in here?"
And she looks over and she kind of gets scared when she sees Gunk, because Gunk is kind of holding this like large, I guess it's an axe, I guess is what you would call it, brandishing, and he's just trembling as this little tiny kid says, "He's like ghost girl." And this little like pale girl is just kind of like waving. She's got like a little burlap sack that's full of something. She's looking at you guys. Her eyes are real. She's got really big kid eyes, and her pupils are fucking blasted. Her pupils are as big as her eyes are.
Oh,
and she's like,
that's creepy looking.
"What's your name?" And she sees you all, and she kind of like walks over to probably to you, Lilith, and kind of like grabs at your hand. "What's your name?"
Oh my god, you let it touch you. Ew. I'm just gonna ignore you.
You're so pretty. Are you saying that out loud? I'm just coming for you. she's like, you're all so pretty, don't you?
What are you doing in the forest?
You're all so bright, don't you see it? What am I here? I live here now. She kind of flits over and kind of sees the, kind of like, she's reaching towards the thing with wings, but can't quite get up high enough.
No.
Let me.
No.
Please.
No, where I'm from,
come down.
Children are contagious.
She's kind of just reaching. She sees now. She goes to Taracus and kind of reaches over and grabs onto you. And she says, You.
Yeah, hi.
It's been so long.
How long?
You don't remember me?
Nope.
And she looks at you all again. She's like, even though she's got like blasted out eye,
my
pupils. And she's got the dirt on her feet. Are you saying that out loud? Or are you just like, what are you saying that you think this is?
Well, to you, but okay.
Are you like, does Taracus? What is Taracus doing?
I'm just like, who is this, Lilith? I mean,
wasn't there something in the temple in like a big vat?
Yeah, the grung?
There was a little girl. Yeah, there was a little girl. Wasn't there?
Yeah.
Kaz isn't here, but yeah, I remember that now.
Since we're doing the meta ing, the little girl in the vat, you think probably was my Cynthia. This is actually.
Oh yeah.
She looks back and she says, don't be like that. It's me. It's Pete.
Petunia. You don't remember? I remember you. She's from the village.
Oh. Are we sure? Because forest things were dangerous last time we were here.
Yeah, but there was more dangerous. Oh, you guys have been gone for so long.
Yeah, what are you doing in here, though?
Well, I don't know. You're flying around. I can't even see you up there. Come down here. I want to hold you in my hand and put you in a small jar.
That's disgusting.
You're so bright, all of you.
So let's play a game. Let's play. Take us to the temple.
Temples? No.
Yep.
No.
Yep.
No.
Yep.
No. No. She kind of puts her hands on her head and starts stomping around. No. No temple. We can go take you to my dad or nowhere. No.
Where's your dad?
Who's your dad?
Who's your daddy? Well,
probably your father. Flying around.
Probably her father. Well, no shit.
Yeah.
If I'm reading these notes right, back me up on this, a note keeper. I'm reading that her father's name was Sue Ellen Mandrake.
Yes. Yes.
What?
I'm looking through my notes. I'm like, fuck,
yes.
What was this?
Yeah. Because that was...
But yes, that's
the father
right.
Had
a boy named Sue.
A boy named Sue. And the female child's name was Pete Unia.
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes. I don't know why I do these things to myself. I don't expect to have to come back to these characters ever again. But now that you guys are back here, Pete is very dirty. You guys are in the forest, and she says, are you guys also hiding out inside the forest like we are? Dad said it was a great idea. And look at us. We're still here.
What do you tell you about the temple?
That you never, ever, ever go there. When people tell you to go there, you say no, and you hold your hands on your head, and you stomp around.
I don't want to go. Aren't you curious?
She looks up at you.
You don't have to take her.
I think you should either let us go or you should come with us.
The camera zooms in, and as you say, don't you kind of want to go? She connects eyes with you. It zooms into her face. Her eyes get even bigger, and she says, yeah.
Let's go then.
She looks at the two of you, and she says, okay, but I gotta... And she reaches over, and she's like picking up all of the mushrooms at your feet. She's like, I gotta... She's stuffing them into her bag. She's like, I have to get more of them, because this is what... it's really the only food that we have here. And it's... But it's also...
Or
it's also
go
really
take the
good.
Food back to your dad. It's okay.
Okay.
You can catch up with us later.
Let's go then. Come on.
No. We're
going
to go to the temple.
Just say no to Taracus.
She's not even listening. She just goes like, let's go. Come on.
Bye.
Yeah.
And she goes away.
She's like, she's running a couple of... she's like into the forest for a moment. She's gone.
Okay.
Was this like this?
No, this was not like this last time. No.
No. Okay.
She pops back in the clearing. She just spills some of these mushrooms, and she's kind of also like, come on, what are you guys doing? We gotta go talk to our dad. You're wasting time. Guys, I can't, you gotta, if I told you,
you
how bright you all are.
You run on and we'll follow.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, I can see all of it.
You run on, we'll follow.
Yeah, yeah. She's like, she runs away. And then she kind of, there's a couple minutes, a couple moments go by. And she comes back in the clearing again. She says, kind of walks a little bit slower. She's like, I have a feeling that you guys aren't going to follow me.
Well, we're
a couple minutes went by when we have gone and walked.
That's why I said moments.
Yeah.
Okay.
A couple moments go by, and she just kind of walks by, back, and she's like, "Why aren't you guys coming? You guys not gonna come?
Well, we've got a certain destination. We've got to go, and it's time. You're limited, is all."
But your food's more important. Take that back to your dad.
Her eyes well up with tears, and you say this, and she starts to.
Oh,
you get like.
Okay.
Oh,
I can
God.
Kill her if you want.
And she's just
no,
like,
don't kill her.
No,
she's an innocence.
No, I'll go.
That's not the objective.
I can just knock
I'll
her out.
Why is she innocent?
Because she's just young and doesn't know
any
better. She walked up to us.
Oh, Petunia.
She rubs her eyes.
You should go find your father, and then we'll come visit you tomorrow.
Okay, you promise? You all promise?
Yeah. We're going to do our best to make it
absolutely.
Back here. We're going to go explore, though, but you need to stay with your dad.
If you hear a big boom, it's probably because we died.
She's like, okay. And she reaches into her pack. She gets out a couple of it's like a, really the nicest mushrooms that she's got in here. She says, she gives one to Tarakas.
Oh, thank you.
She gives one to you, Fago. She holds it out. I don't know what you do with it.
I'll take it. I'm
okay.
Take the girl.
She gives one to you, Lilith. Gunk snatches it out of her hand. She kind of holds one up to the flitting,
all right.
flying
yeah, thank
creature.
You.
And she says,
so
in case,
nice, honey.
If you need to eat anything, because there's not much that you can really eat here if you're here for very long, it's pretty good. She kind of laughs a little bit. She says, it's also pretty good if you, you know, grind it up and then you just kind of put it in your cheek and just kind of,
And just chew on it?
Yeah, you can make you guys see the prettiest lion
drug.
I know.
Yeah, we sold some to some soldiers before they started getting really violent. We had to go into the forest.
Oh.
They called it Veil Dust.
Oh, yeah. Veil Dust?
But shh. They don't know it. They don't know where we. They don't know where it comes from. I shouldn't have told you guys where it's at.
Didn't it come from the ground?
Yeah,
that's her point.
She gets really defensive all of a sudden. She's like, actually, you know what? You're right. You guys all know too much.
Well, I don't remember shit. I'm really forgetful.
I think I'll have to kill all of you.
Okay.
I'm just.
Oh, you're such a joke.
I know, right?
Yeah.
She's kind of like.
This is why you never.
She just fades back into the forest, like Homer Simpson into the bushes.
Okay, we need to move fast.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
So I have this thing that I can do where we can go through the trees.
Huh?
Well, there was this big tree right outside the temple, and if we go through this tree, I can get us to that one.
You didn't think to bring this up when we first landed?
No,
well, I mean,
that
was
me.
Moments ago, right?
This is like an hour and a half ago.
How,
oh my gosh.
How would we know to ask that, honey, huh? No one asked me anything.
I mean,
so
but yes,
I
now sure.
To myself.
Yes.
Gunk's like, but then we wouldn't have gotten to in-flight meal. We would have just taken plants.
No, that's ridiculous.
Oh, shit. We could have taken it from... Wow.
Yeah.
You had an infant mule.
I ate yours.
Oh,
no. Friend. Huh.
Oh.
Probably wasn't any good.
How many of...
I'm
going to
hand you
group?
My mushroom, by the way. Just FYI.
Okay, I'll put it in my pocket.
Yeah. They're all blue and green, glowing
in
the dark.
There's five of us?
Yeah.
Okay, that should work.
Remember glowworms?
Yes. It
looks a lot like that.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
That's awesome.
The creepy fuckers?
Yeah.
Oh.
You know it.
Like what?
It's got like
the
it's glow in the dark.
Remember
like the little
glow
in the dark toys that were like not plushies but like kind of like soft plastic.
They had like the glowy face.
Yeah.
And they're like a little worm but a soft body that
glows. Did you not remember?
Glow?
This? I have one in my garage.
Yeah.
You like hugged it and it lit
in my
up.
Tote.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
I legit asked for one as an adult, and my mom got it for me.
I'm shocked by that.
I'll show it.
I didn't have one either, but I knew people did.
Okay.
I didn't have one either. My cousin did.
That's adorable.
Yeah. So
let's see. I'll probably like it.
Okay.
You're like, it's cute. It's creepy.
Let's see. Anyway, back where we were talking.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yes,
I did that. The scene ends as you guys hear the creepy child laughter fading off into the distance. As you guys send her off, you guys are left pocketing these strange veil dust, or rather the mushrooms that are you can crush into veil dust. And
weren't we told to like keep our distance from the veil dust guys?
No, we were actually told to keep our distance from the village. who had veil dust.
Oh.
Yeah. So.
But is that because of the veil dust?
You know, they weren't specifically clear on that part. I didn't ask any clarifying questions.
Not something we should discuss. We should just go to the temple.
Yeah, everyone. I mean,
we're walking, aren't we?
Why doesn't everyone roll me a constitution?
I already gave mine away.
You gave yours away? Yeah. everyone else make me a constitution saving throw, but not for the reasons you think. It's not the mushrooms, but you also don't need to make one.
Oh, okay.
As you guys are having this conversation.
Con save throw?
That was really crazy. Let's see. Okay.
Let's talk to me.
15.
20. That's all really good. All you guys, there's no damage. There's no ill effect. There's only a slight tinniness in your mouth as like something feels like behind your ear just kind of like rings really loud as he makes the point. Thago makes the point. I can't remember how you said it, but basically like, so are we...
Stop discussing. Let's go.
Let's go. Everyone else that what's the word I'm looking for? Dallies for even a second longer. You guys feel this really bad tinnitus for just a couple seconds, and then it's gone.
Gross.
Again, it's in these... it's not quite the earpiece. It's something in your guys' head, in your brains. So you guys begin to hoof it towards the... But you can still talk as you guys are moving. You're discussing, I believe, some of the capabilities of your local friendly neighborhood druid. Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I could do that, but I can only do it once.
So we may need it
to leave. Should we use it after we go to the temple then and make a quick escape?
No, that's a great question. Hey, dipshits who can presumably talk into my ear, do you have an escape plan for us, or are we just, like, fucked?
Are we getting picked up again? That was nice.
As you remember the briefing, there is also a voice that reminds you of a... the exfil is the same as it was when you guys headed up, and then the same as it was in the last mission. There will be alternative transportation, another dropship ready at the extraction point whenever the confirmation of the job has been received. From your survey, what's it called? Your debriefing, your briefing, you know that the exfil is at the very top of the temple where you guys were supposed to be dropped off to begin with.
Okay, that tracks. Yeah, sorry. First time lead one of these fucking things. You shouldn't let me lead them. But anyway,
Yeah, you can see like a cuts off. You guys are schlepping it towards this temple.
We're making friends. We're having fun.
Heading towards this temple, there's a there's a long walk ahead of you. It's several hours now. It's a pretty big
forest. Wait, are we doing your warp thingy?
We can, but I feel like... Oh, the dropship.
Yeah, they'll pick us up once we're done.
How will they know where to find us?
Ooh. They have trackers on all. They can tell where we're all at right now.
Mm. But we're also going to like cause an explosion, so I feel like that would be easy to see.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and do the thing.
You know, before we do that, though, we came into a lot of resistance when we first got that into the side of that temple. So, maybe we should buff up a little bit before we head inside. Because we'll be, like, right there, and then there may be action, you know? So...
I got all the buffs that I need, and you'll see this little, like, shimmer of an invisible thing floating next to it.
I am... swole.
Alright, well, I need protection. Lilith, do you want something?
She's really not. What do you have in mind?
It just keeps you from, like, completely dying, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, temporarily...
What do you mean temporarily? What do you mean?
I mean, you can pop back up when something tries to get you.
Oh, you can almost die once.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay.
Like freebie.
Kind of, yeah.
Everybody gets one.
Well, I don't have one for everybody.
Oh, Lilith gets one.
If you want it.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to cast Death Ward on Lilith and myself.
Come. Is the party going to take advantage of... Lilith's... I can't remember the name of the spell.
Transport via plants.
Via plants.
Fago would very much so encourage it.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to cast it.
And we have 6 seconds for everybody to shuffle through the tree. And we're going to be teleported to the tree right outside the temple.
Cool. Perfect.
All right. Okay. And here we go. And she's going to touch the tree and then walk through.
I'll follow. Yep, we all go.
Yep.
Bing.
Boom, boom, boom.
Okay.
Boom.
Yep. Ding.
Checking my notes really quick. I'm going to check
what's in head for. And I was like, oh shit, there's one more.
Oh, yeah, dunk.
That was a
fool. Okay, that's what I thought. Okay, all right. Stop reading the fine print. No, you gotta read the fine print.
No, nothing.
Nice. Okay, so you guys are heading into this tree. The last one to go in. So which tree are you going? Are you picking? What kind of tree? Can you describe it for me?
It's probably like, I mean, it's got to be big. Mm-hmm. So she can like hug this tree.
Mm-hmm.
I'm imagining it's some big like elm.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. I don't know what trees look
you're
like.
You're engaged to a Douglas fir.
So it's like a person-sized?
Yeah, it's got to be person-sized.
Okay.
And I mean, these are big trees here, right?
Some of them are. There's all kinds of
forest.
Just person-sized.
Yeah.
Final answer.
Yeah.
Okay. So
gunk-sized.
You open up the tree. You guys all go through. The last person to go through is Gunk. And he's me like, boom, Winnie the Pooh is the large creature. Because remember, he's a large creature.
Oh. Then I will cast...
Because he's just like, you guys can see his snoot.
Oh, dude,
snoot.
I love this.
Then
you guys can
cast,
see his snoot.
Cast...
He's like, ooh. He looks at you on the other side and he's like,
He's so stupid. Okay, reduce. And I'll touch him and cast reduce on him.
And he's like, this little time, he's like,
look at you! What the heck
is this?
Little baby.
What you do to me?
Little baby. Little baby.
You've just got on a medium size.
Yeah,
he's still kind of like, he's got like a smaller, he's like, insult. This is now a much smaller albino. I can't say massive anymore, but a little crocodilian.
Mm-hmm.
Like a crocodilio.
It's a concentration up to a minute, so I can drop it whenever.
So it's enough for him to like into the tree and come tumbling out the other side as a little medium
crocodile.
Yeah,
so he
crocodile.
Is halved in all dimensions. And his weight is reduced to 1/8 of normal.
Oh, that's great.
toothpick?
Just him?
Yeah, I just touched him.
Just him? What about his stuff?
Is that with the equipment?
It's everything
right
with it, yeah. It's everything, like, if it's on him, it...
So he's got to go, I don't want to have to be like a really big axe.
Yeah.
Like,
the target's weapons also shrink to match its new size.
That's great. Okay. So he's got like a little normal size axe now.
Also, if all these weapons are reduced, the target's attacks with them deal 1d4 less damage.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, okay.
Because if you enlarge,
yeah,
it's the reverse.
Yeah.
Like, before we do that, like, I'll...
Just go back up. Like,
yeah. So as soon as we're through...
That'll be a fucking fun scene.
So as soon as he's through, I'm going to be like, boom!
So like,
pick,
pops out.
Look at that.
Wow. He's he's regular size. Pops back
You're
out.
You're welcome.
Well, you could have gotten like sliced right in half there, Gunk. Boy, that was nice of you, Dusty.
Says, thank you. Don't ever do again. Don't like being small fry.
Sure.
And kind of looking right at your fingers and just kind of is nodding like a big dumb crocodile. The party is now exited. Lilith, you wanted to tell us where we dropped us off at?
There was a big tree outside the temple, so we're just
Mm-hmm. Right at the edge of it. There's a clearing around this temple. The temple itself is, if I remember right, it is a pyramid that is. There's a term for this. A ziggurat.
Oh, yeah.
Is what that's called.
Mm-hmm.
So think about the Aztec kind of pyramids that were like that. Is that who that was?
Mayan
temples. Yeah. That's who it was. Thank you. Mayan temples.
That's
like
similar.
That. Square-shaped blocks, made of square-shaped blocks. They're tiered as it steps up to the top that has vines crawling all up it. And at the top, you guys know that there is an entrance into a cavern below that is kept very cold. And has a strange station underneath of it, several floors below. So as you guys are seeing this clearing, It looks clear for the moment, but it almost as you guys have a moment to say, I think the coast is clear. You see walking from each side two familiar things. There are several small, there's medium guardians. If you guys remember these forest guardians, look kind of like Wendigo things. Two of the medium ones are on a patrol, kind of walking around the perimeter of it. And then rounding the corner, one kind of on its, not really wandering a perimeter, it's just kind of, it's just randomly wandering. Is the massive tree-shaped forest guardian, we called it, that is as tall as any of the other trees, has mushrooms growing off of it, and a very distinctive butthole head that Nerd threw a grenade towards, if you remember.
Can we see that from the top?
You can only see that from the top.
Maybe it was bending over.
Yeah.
This thing is slowly stomping.
It's a rosebud.
Around the edges of this ziggurat. And now that you know what to look for, you guys can, looks like the ziggurat itself is alive, but you guys know that that's because the vines on it are all writhing, kind of searching along the edges of the stone, trying to look for things like the sarlacc pit.
Mm-hmm.
This is the scene that you guys see as you guys are coming up to the edges of the forest.
Where is the butthole creature in relation to us?
The butthole creature is currently in between you and the ziggurat itself, but it doesn't see you at the moment, and
it's
just
like patrolling.
Kind of, it's just loosely. The other ones are doing a better job of patrolling. This one just seems to be wanton wandering with less purpose, just kind of stomping along.
So we like wait for an opening. And then we run, right?
Well, I mean, all the vines. We might as well call it a day. No.
Okay. No. Here's the deal. Like, if we want, like, maybe we don't even run. Maybe we just walk at, like, a quickish pace, and I can just, like, blast the shit out of the vines as we run and, like, clear a path of the vines.
Oh, that does make sense, yeah. Careful of that creature, though. It regenerates. There's no really killing it.
That's why we wait till it's, like, away from us.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I just want to make sure everybody knew that. It's scary, so yeah. By the way, if we could not do this job, it would be great. Could we, like,
if you want to die, yeah.
Well,
you literally said you were gonna do the fucking job, so do the fucking job.
Do you want to make me another Constitution saving throw?
No.
Is it the familiar ringing in your ear? Happens again. Plus three.
It is seven.
What's the total?
Seven.
I have my roller here. This is going off. Oh, what did I do? I minimized the window. Come back. Let's go. Rather than do it myself, let's go. And it's D. Thank you. Just one time, please. One ping only. So Trachis, there's this ring in your ear. As you feel 18 psychic damage pierce in your brain. And again, this is just sort of like a level one, sort of like... You guys, those of you around, you can see Trachis's ear just starts to bleed.
I was going to say, Trachis.
Yeah.
It's just these
mosquitoes in this forest. I know it.
Red bluish liquid that's sparking as it comes out of his ear.
He got blood.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Out your ear.
It's getting work. It's getting
my robe. I don't think that's normal.
So come on, let's win the game.
Yeah. Okay. Game it up.
That's right. I don't like win them. I like, you know.
I know you fucking lose them. I lost 500 gold on you once. You fucking.
You should have known better.
You guys knew each other. I didn't know that.
No.
Oh, you know of each other.
We what?
You know of each other?
Oh. It's not what I heard.
Oh.
What's your passive perception?
24.
Okay.
Jesus.
Son of a bitch.
That's
really?
Nice.
Okay, that's good to know.
You should observe it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Helps.
Okay. Got it. I'm just going to do this. This is more fun this way. You get one of these. We're going to whisper. I don't do this very often.
Okay.
Oh, it's a whisper.
Yeah? Oh, my God.
Sorry.
There are crickets right now.
No, I actually can't hear.
Wait, are there crickets in
this
forest?
I could if you both would shut up.
No, you're not. No, don't cheat.
I'm not.
He just told us to shut up.
And then again,
it
comes later on.
It's not my fault if he whispers yells.
Oh, we all heard that one, though.
Our shiny thing.
The butthole.
I'm
shiny.
Shiny. You are shiny.
You're sparkling.
So shiny.
When you shake I guess the boss show it to the sun at least 30 minutes a day. That's
no.
not real.
Oh, no.
It's called sunning. The party is... Again, you're witnessing Turok as his ears bleed, as he suddenly is back on program.
Turok, we gotta stay on target.
Right, I know. Okay.
Okay.
Staying on target.
Right.
Right, so what's the plan? What are we doing?
We wait till the thing's around, and then we run.
Okay.
And you're gonna
and as we get close, as we get, like, within, okay. like, yeah, closer, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, people are sneaking into trying to find an opening to sneak in.
She's, like, psyching herself up.
I need a group stealth check as you guys are headed in.
I'm gonna wear my stealth wig.
Everyone is looking to beat. Let's roll for it. The two people are looking. First guy on patrol. Second one on patrol. Okay.
Oh, that's not good.
This will be a two legged. There's kind of two legs to this. First leg. Let's talk about who can beat. Well, what's his plus? Since this is a he's trying to perceive, and you guys are trying to hide. Who's got above a 12? All right, so more than half. Okay. So the first phase, Taraka starts to go out a little bit too soon, and it's right at the last moment. Everyone reaches out, and grabs him, pulls him back. Right as the first one of these starts to turn from his patrol and starts to stomp back the other direction. And everyone pulls him back, and the rest of the group kind of waits a second and has a clear moment and races to the base of the ziggurat. And you guys are kind of like posted up at the base of the ziggurat. So the second phase, now that you guys have passed this first sentry, there's this massive kind of wandering one.
Oh boy.
I need a second, for the second leg, one more group stealth check for this one's perception.
Oh, that's way better.
Do I have advantage on you?
Zone patrol.
I don't think I do. That's
as the better. Second one comes back around. Alright. This guy rolled much better. Who's can beat an 18?
Ooh, not this time.
Okay.
Nope.
So
Gonk, help me out.
No, yeah. Gonk actually didn't roll, but that's a good tiebreaker. Because it wouldn't have done it.
I had 18 exactly.
Oof. That sucked. So
a good stealth, but a roll low.
The party is posted up right behind like the base of the ziggurat. As the party was up against the pushing up against it, the vines just sort of like snake and are just like kind of touching and feeling, and they can kind of touch and feel everybody. Everyone's getting these like wet slaps around their kind of face and upper body as they kind of are tasting and feeling and finding you, and these vines begin to like slowly wrap around any extremities you guys would have.
Yeah, thank you.
Because I said while we were going up, I was going to start blasting the vines before we got there.
Oh, I didn't hear that, sorry. So you're just kind of like shooting some vines on the way in?
Yeah, I just want to like Eldritch.
He was going to clear a path
slap
for us.
Okay. Okay, I would have made you roll for disadvantage then, because you guys are on stealthing, but you guys already failed it.
Oh, look.
Even worse. You guys already got caught. So we'll say that it's because you guys are blasting these vines that they don't grab you. You guys are Eldritch blasting. So these vines get blasted right as they're reaching out for you. Right? No vines. And then from that last second, there's just a above the top.
Oh my god!
Here's these eldritch blasts. And from the other side of the stomping from the other side of the temple is this massive forest guardian that kind of is seeing you all like the abominable snowman.
We just gotta run under it, get in the hole in the top.
And I need everyone to roll initiative. I don't have the perfect map for it. I'll just use this one instead. We'll just say that this is like, imagine the ziggurat, imagine that's the main hole.
Lord.
Actually, I probably need to make a better map than that.
I miss Nerd's initiative.
How do I do this? How do I want to make this the right map? Because I don't want to
fucking. I might as well get it out of the way.
That's fair. I mean, it could be worse.
No.
Layer one.
Think what it would be like if we had negatives.
Layer
like
one.
Negative dice rolls, not just
yeah.
I don't know what I'm saying. I'm tired.
Layer one.
Same here.
Sorry.
Layer one.
Helping,
layer one.
Layer one. Oh, I see, I see.
I'm just like, this is sort of like edge. This is like the very edge of
tears.
It. Yeah. I don't have the full. I think it's downstairs, but I'm not going to go get it.
Okay.
I think you guys will be you guys will be done with it before I fucking.
Looks like a peanut butter cup.
Okay. Oh. It's like a peanut butter cup. And it's stomping down from one side. We'll just put you guys all, take these guys back.
Oh, it's the butt.
They're all over here.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take them. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
We'll put you guys all on the edge just over here because it's easier for me to. You want to trade it out?
Yeah, I'm in my stealth wig.
Here you go.
Stealth wig.
Yeah. Is your person out? Because you would have been.
Huh?
Is your person out?
Your
tentacle. No. Okay, we'll have him out by here. Where do you guys want to be? You guys are all kind of posted up all on the edge. You guys can kind of tell me where you guys want to be, like, organized. You guys are going to up against the edge. And this thing is in here. You guys are basically trying to get inside. Just kind of slip around it and get inside, right? I think is what you guys said. Oh, where's Gunk?
Where's Gunk?
I was painting him downstairs. Gunk is just going to be, Gunk's going to be this person. I'm so sorry, because he's small anyway. Oh, he's big again. Fuck. He's downstairs.
Do I get a person?
Oh, yeah. Who is you? You're a pixie person, right? Mm-hmm. I don't have a great flyer, but you'll be this little person right now.
As long as I just know
where you are.
Yeah, that's
cool. What's our
timing? You're small, too.
We'll probably do this anyway. You need a little card. And I made one.
Oh, an initial
for you.
Yeah.
Well, I lost it. it was Dusty.
Yeah.
The nose dive.
Dusty.
It was almost Dusty Dewberry.
Talk to me about everyone's initiative. I got to roll for the Guardian. All right. 25 to 20?
Ooh.
Nobody? 20 to 15?
19.
19 is T. 15? 10.
14.
10.
14. 10.
10 3.
Lilith. Gunk. Didn't roll. Gunk got a 9, so he's above you. And the forest. I didn't make one for them. Forest Guardian. I'll just make him for this for now because I can't. What is a 13 sitting here? Faygo, what'd you have?
10.
So he's above you. So that's the Forest Guardian just for now. Fix that in a minute. Okay. Top of the round, Tarakas, you are up. You're on the very edge of the ziggurat, back up against the wall. The Forest Guardian leering over the top of it has caught you guys at the sounds of these eldritch blasts. However, the vines at the moment seem to not be a nuisance as they've been shot away at the moment.
I'm actually going to try to indicate some peaceful signs to this big guardian because we're still undead. I'm pretty sure that got us a free passage last time. I don't remember if.
No, it fixed you as long as you weren't in visual. They still could see. They still could tell you are.
Just, okay.
They could smense. they could smell sense.
Yeah, they could smense
you from a long distance. Like the forest knew where you were, like the way something could tell an ant was crawling on them beforehand, until you guys were hiding yourselves.
Smense, and I was like, yeah, you could smell it.
Smense, totally smensed it.
I'm going to.
These steps, if you recall, are about 10 feet, 10 feet up and 10 feet over. So they're kind of squares, right? Big square blocks. There are two tiers, sort of two layers, as it were, that are flat before you get to the top floor where the hole on the top and there's ladders that go, or rather there were long before they had brought it away. It's just an opening that you guys usually tied a rope to and then dropped into beforehand.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I'm just going to cast blindness at it and see if I can blind this creature as I am making my way around it. Okay. It's a con save on his part. It's part.
Con save. All right. Con save is 15.
It needs to be a 16. So.
Okay, it's a fail.
It fails. The target is either blinded or deafened. I chose blinded. So at the end of each of its turn, the target can make a constitution saving throw. On a success, the spell ends. So it lasts for a minute otherwise.
So it's blinded?
Yep, it's blinded.
Blinded.
I think I got it, everybody. I can't see us.
Are you sure?
Nope.
But I'm going to scramble up and try to make my way around.
All right.
Dodge into the vines.
Scrambling up. Remember, it's 10 feet up to get up. So it's this first hop is 10 feet. So 10 feet up to get up the side. 10, so 10 feet. So you're to right here.
20 feet a moment, yeah.
20 feet. So we're going to go 5, 10. You want to go away from it?
Yeah.
15, and then 15, 20?
Yep.
Up to the top?
Back toward you. 20 feet.
You could probably do the same thing up over here.
That works too, yeah.
Okay, just like, so staying put there?
As far as I can move, I think, yeah.
I think you're right after I'm going the vertical climbing and then moving over a couple times. So 5, 10, 15, 20, and then 20, 25, 30. I think I gave you one extra, but that's okay.
Well, you can back me down, that's fine.
It's okay. I don't have a 3D dimensional thing to give it to you anyway.
What did you cast?
Yeah, what was your action?
Blindness.
Okay.
Blindness. And then I moved, and I don't really have any bonus actions I can do.
Takes concentration, right?
Yes, I've got it. Yep.
Okay.
But he failed it, so he is blind.
Right? Yes.
Yes, he's blinded currently. Anything else on your turn?
I think that's it.
That brings us to Dusty, the flitting little pixie barbarian.
Cool. She's gonna use her little dragonfly wings, and I've got 40 walking speed.
40.
So my flight, is the same thing. It's 40. So I'm gonna use my action and my movement to go 80 as far up to the top as I can get.
Okay, so that's, and you don't really, you're flying, so you're not really restricted by these, the climbing to check. So 80's just like, goes right by it. You're kind of like hovering.
So does it get me to the top?
You can get you to the
Sweet.
Top.
So I'll kind of, yeah, like hover on the edge.
Or on the edge?
You know, like, so she can look down at the others, I guess.
Yeah.
It was easy.
She's like flying right up. You're gonna hold an action for anything? You're just gonna like stand put there? Or was that your dashing action to do it?
That was my action and my my movement.
She goes right by this massive forest guardian that is blinded, can't quite see you. Okay. On its turn. On its turn.
Hi.
This is gonna be great. On its turn, as you, it's kind of like swatting randomly as it's blinded. As Dusty, as you are flying in. It's swiping blindly, so it does have disadvantage. But it is swiping. Let's see. This, let me pull up the stat block. So it makes two attacks. Technically, they call it slam. All right, first of two attacks with disadvantage. Roll two dice at a time. Disadvantage. Oh, that is a nat 20.
Ooh.
And a 2.
So
total of 12 to hit. Misses. The second attack. I don't know if you guys remember fighting this thing earlier. Did you redo your hair? It's more purple all of a sudden than it used to.
It's also next to the green, and those are complimentary.
Yeah.
Right.
The second two, the disadvantage, are actually both, they're both 12 on the dice, which is a 22. To hit.
22 to hit?
Oh, yeah.
You do actually hit me on that
They're both the same, they're both the same value. Alright.
Surprise.
This one's not great. This one's not a great hit. So I'm gonna do the auto roller here. That is the 6. One time, please. Oh, there's a couple ones in there. That is a 19 bludgeoning damage. As this, again, this hand that's in a flattened kind of mallet state just... Like a tree, getting a tree falling on you.
Dick.
The only thing that maybe stops you is that you're so small that some of the branches stop the worst of it. And it's this second of its slam attacks hit you. The, what else can it do while it's blind? Can it do anything else? Anything else? I don't, well, I gave it some initiative, so it'll be out on its own turn. Will it move at all? It can feel that it got something, and so it's just kind of bellowing out. Right in Tarakas' face, but Tarakas doesn't seem to know you're there yet, as it's kind of got these cloudy, milky eyes. It's bending over, and you can see that this mushroom on the top of its head looks exactly like a butthole. Faygo.
So you just got hit, or you got grappled?
I got hit.
Just got hit, okay. So I'm going to skirt the other direction from where Traxxas is.
Okay.
And just move my full movement 60 feet as far as I can, basically. And I...
You're going to climb up, so it's 5, 10,
Yeah. 60 feet, dang.
Well, 15, by the time 20, he's actually in 30. Oh, no, opposite side of truck.
Oh, okay, so where is that? 15, 20, I can't see, 25, I can't see what I just did there, 5, 10, 15, 25, 30, going all the way around.
And 30 more.
35, 40, 45, do we go up?
Yeah.
50, 55, 60, because you go up another 10 feet to get on this one. Okay. So that's 60 feet of movement?
Yeah, that's done then.
Are you done? Okay. All right. Not bad, not bad.
Let me check.
Movement and a dash. I'm just going to move this a bit because I feel like the camera could move a bit. Oops, that's the wrong direction.
Yeah, that's all I'm going to do this turn.
Even though it's not the right map, that'll do. That's end of your turn?
Yeah.
All right. Gunk, who is not, also not the right mini. Got a couple things to grab on break. Gunk is going to, he can't go very far. 5, 10. 20. You're up to here. Uh-oh. Can really only get to here. Gunk doesn't even know what's going on. So Gunk's just kind of running. But rather than dashing, Gunk just sees, you know, when you're a hammer, everything looks like a nail. And he's running by a tree leg with a massive axe. So he's running by, but he does stop to take one big swing at it. So he's going to swing at it.
With advantage because it's blind.
With advantage because it's blind. And the second one is a nat 20. So well done, Gunk. I'll use the auto roller. Use the auto roller. Gunk does okay. Look at that. Gunk just like sinks the axe once into it. And then just like sees Will kind of like running past him. He's like, wait up. And he's just like pulls the thing out of the tree trunk of a leg. But it is Lilith's turn now as Gunk is kind of staying right where he's at next to it.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna use hidden pathways and I'm gonna teleport 60 feet up onto the ziggurat. So however far that's gonna get me. And then I'm going to move an additional 30 feet.
So we're gonna go on the side with
I'm gonna go on the side with Tarakas actually.
Shook would be one but one less.
The cold side.
You're gonna be around like you're basically around the edge. I don't have a great ledge that goes all the way around, but that ledge is right with the whole thing. Right.
Okay.
So you're right on the edge.
Okay.
So you're not on the level, you're just right. Just same thing, same as Fago on
just
the other
below
side.
It.
Yep.
Okay.
Because yep, both you move 60 feet from basically the same place.
Well, she moved 90.
You move 90 feet?
Well, I could move an additional 30 feet as my movement, because that was just my bonus action.
Okay.
But I don't want to leave Tarakas that far behind.
Got but you'll be up a tier, though, so you might still have visual.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, go ahead and move me the 30 feet.
Top up?
You'd have the high ground.
I'm only 6'2", Lilith.
Kind of up here.
I'm gonna
do this. I'm gonna put you. Because you have 30 feet, I'll put you up, so you can know that you're up and on that edge. You can see down into this dark. It's just like a dark shaft that goes all the way down, and it goes down and down and down. And above it, you can see Dusty's right there on the edge, waiting for you. Mm-hmm. Lilith, that is your turn.
And then I'm going to hold action. I'm gonna hold Frostbite. So if that hits any party member, I'm going to hit it back.
Okay. Got it. Top of the round. On top of the round.
Oh no, the mushrooms.
That question mark.
Top of the round, there's a few things that begin to squirm around the edges of the of the temple. A couple of them are shot, a couple of them come back. We'll just put one. Okay, it's fun. Grab the left one. Three. They're just there, though. They appear. Their action is to, like, crawl up. It's going to appear, like, from the stonework. There's these new vines. And these vines are these big, thick, ropey green vines that have red, sharp thorns on them. They almost look like red glass coming out of them. And they're hungry. They can almost smell you. So they are popping up near Tarakas, near Lilith, and kind of in between where Fago had just ran. But they are just popping up on their turn. Tarakas, it is your turn.
And I still need to get up two tiers or one tier?
You need to get up one more tier. You're on the second tier currently.
Okay. Zoop, zoop. Can I move around? Can I just go straight up the tier without getting in the way of that vine?
You can go like, yeah, 5, 10, maybe 15, 20. 20 feet will put you right up next to Dusty.
I will head that direction.
Okay. And again, you're not leaving their sphere. Oh, you're right there. You're not leaving anything's sphere of influence. You would technically be entering one of the vine's sphere of influence.
Can I use my action to disengage?
You can.
I will do that and move an additional 10 feet away from it.
Okay, which direction are you away from it?
Straight toward the door.
And toward the hole?
Oh.
You're on the edge.
Yes.
Of glory.
I'm gonna hold it up.
Okay.
Oh, there's a rope, right?
There is no rope. That looks like the place there would have been. You guys used the rope and tied it off last time. That's what you guys did, right?
I don't remember.
Well, it's really nice playing with you. You fall through the hole.
Right?
There's like a running up and...
Yeah. There used to be a rope here. Help!
Tarakas, I got you.
But can I move my other, my additional 10 feet around the edge?
Yeah, so, over by me.
I'll allow it.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Another 10 feet, so 10 over closer.
Okay. Am I still within its influence, though? Like, if I left, would it grapple me?
You disengage.
You disengage.
You disengage, so yeah, you're good to go.
Okay, I just didn't know how far they could reach out. That's
what you just about. Left its sphere of influence? Okay. Probably just barely. You're probably close to it. Let me check. I have the stat block right here. Let me just check. Well, let me just look. But... you're just barely out of it because you're up. Your elevation helps.
Oh, okay.
Just by based on my math. No. So you're good. But either way, it's still blinded. Is that ending yet?
I think I'm going to do a bonus action.
It's still on.
Is what still on?
His concentration spell.
It's not concentration.
It wasn't concentration. I saw con and I was like, oh, concentration. It was the con save.
Okay.
So my bad.
Just blinded for forever?
For a minute.
Oh, damn.
Or it saves at the end of each of its turns, too. It can re-roll the saving throw. So you should have rolled.
Okay. That's a 19.
Okay, then it's not blinded anymore.
Okay. Good to know.
I think I'm going to use a bonus action to cast... Can I even cast it, actually? Oh, I can't cast it. Sanctuary on myself.
Okay, action.
That was a bonus action.
That's a bonus
action. I'm done now. Yep.
Okay. Let's see. Okay. Good to know. Dusty. You're on the edge. You can see down this dark shaft.
You two have a way to get down? You're good?
Nope.
Yep. I got you, Tarakas.
Oh, good. Okay, never mind.
No longer blinded.
She's going to go
down. You're flying away. All right, as you leave its sphere of influence, it's taking one swipe because it can see now.
Yep.
Attack of opportunity. That's a 19 on the die, which makes it a 29 to hit.
Yes.
All right. Set this back up again.
Ooh, does that mean my held action is going to go off?
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, that's a better roll. 28 bludgeoning damage. As this thing kind of brings down its knife edge, as it can see you and with a little bit more dexterity, swats this, even this small creature, out of the sky, kind of giving you a little bit of a boost downwards for 28, and you're having it, right?
I'm not raging yet.
Oh, you're not raging. Slapping it, this small creature, like a fly, and it goes down to the darkness and it kind of smug, but it does trigger your held action.
So I need a con save.
Con save. This dice has been rolling hot. 17.
Okay, that failed. So you're gonna take some cold damage. It's not the best, but that's 11.
11?
Yeah.
Cold damage, what is it like? Isn't that like that? Nothing's that. Alright, 11. Total of, where am I at? Okay. Got it. That's your held action. That was Dusty's movement and the reaction to the... any action from you?
So, I guess how far down?
I had written down here that this thing goes down 90 feet. Does that sound like that sounds right to you guys?
Sure, I think so.
I have a pretty loose notes, but basically there's a... It goes down several stories that is enough to make it pretty dark. Pretty dark as a pinpoint of light down below. There is some ambient light down the tunnel. Looks like there's kind of slow pulsating dim purple. You guys remember this is similar to what you guys had seen last time.
Can I cast fairy fire on myself? Like, it has, is it on an object, or is each object in a 20-foot cube?
I don't know
range?
Why you would cast it on yourself, but I don't know.
Is this just light?
The whole point of it is to see invisible creatures.
Is it? I thought it was a... Well, I'm thinking of dancing lights.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Something,
yeah. Yeah. Different effects.
So she will go down. If she can see the pinpoint of light, it's fine. She's going to go down 60 feet. Like, it's 30 feet, and then she's doing an action to get down as well. So 60 feet total.
60 feet of the way down?
Yep.
All right. You can see that this purple light begins to, ambient light begins to get a little bit brighter as you get down a little bit farther. All right.
It's dusty.
It's turn. Let's see. Dusty's down in there. Down below. What can I do? It's facing y'all. It's going to... it's got this crocodile. And it's gonna be taking two attacks. Not with disadvantage. First is 16 is still enough to meet his. Let's do the second attack too. That way I can just do easier rolling of damage if it works. And that's an 18. So two attacks, two hits on Gunk, the dice roller. 18. And an 18? Is it broken? No, it's working. It just rolled three 18s in a row. Okay. Okay. That's not really random generation, but I'll take it. Six. No, it's 30. Okay. All right. I'm bad at math. 36. All right. Gunk is... Gunk's bloodied because I've been mean to Gunk. Falling out of the thing. But Gunk takes two really big hits from this thing. Gunk doesn't ever notice. So he's just this white this albino crocodile is bloodied. You guys notice it before he does. But Gunk's taking a couple hits and is bloodied.
Ooh.
Those two hits are pretty hard. The movement-wise, though, he sees everyone kind of going down to the hole. And is going to take a couple steps. And is going to see what he can do. He's going to crawl up on the edge. But he's going to get up onto it. So his sphere of influence is kind of like all up in it. But he's just kind of over the edge looking at everyone. Kind of be like... looking like he's going to swipe at somebody. But you don't know who. Faygo, you're up.
Make him pucker.
I'm going to climb up the wall to get onto the ledge. So 10 foot of movement,
yep,
right?
10.
And then I'll Eldritch Blast him.
Okay.
Sorry. I like sound effects.
Thank you.
Fuck me. Those are not good. So that is a 12.
12 a miss.
And a 15.
15 also just misses.
Yeah. Oh. I suppose I will then... Bonus action.
Sorry, dudes.
No, it's
just under its natural armor.
Wait, is there something that would be better to do for that? No, it has to be that. I'll bonus action my shlormy tentacle thing. Next to him on this side, I guess. Whatever. Yeah, whatever. Just in range of the thing.
Yeah, so it can take a couple whacks at it.
Yep, and it'll go ahead and hit. Or attempt to hit.
Yep.
Hey, that might, because the other one's close, though. So that's 17 to hit?
17 will hit.
Okay, so that does 2d8.
So you're using a tentacle on the butthole?
Yep. Just right at it. 10 frost damage.
10 frost damage. Okay.
I didn't realize that's frost damage. It's interesting. Okay, 10 frost damage, and it is slowed by 10 foot.
It's slowed.
Right at the ass.
Got it.
I wanted to push it to the end, but...
Oh,
Okay.
Beggars can't be choosers.
Oh, I thought you were anything else in your turn?
No, that's... Well...
10 feet of movement, bonus.
No, because I'll just be like, do you have a good way to get down this thing?
No idea.
I can fly.
Everybody?
Maybe you and Tarakas.
I mean, I'll end my turn, because I'm not going to jump down the hole.
Yeah. Gunk, on its turn, is pissed that it's trying to get away, and will jump, use his movement to jump up. 10, it's pretty much all of his movement to get up to the edge of it. Take him another swing.
He's so slow.
He is pretty slow. Oh, Gunk, a 3. Aww. What's your plus?
Add 2 for flanking.
2 is 5. Okay. Well, that gets him to a 15, which is not enough.
That's looking. Sad.
So Gunk takes a big swing, is not able to get there, clangs onto the ground right next to him, having just barely missed him. Gunk's really messed up in the head with his inner ear is really weird when he was reduced and now he's too big. It's like he still doesn't have his balance back.
He still has dirt in his nostrils.
Yeah, yeah. Lilith, you're up.
Gunk's slightly smaller than before.
I think I was little bigger than this.
Everything shrank.
Okay. So...
Tarakas, are you ready to fly?
No, I never am, but I mean, I'm willing.
Okay, good. I'm gonna wild shape into a giant eagle.
Oh, not that.
I'm going to grab Tarakas.
Careful with your claws.
And fly down.
Okay.
I can go 80 feet.
Lilith and Tarakas. All right. As you, you go eagle first.
Yes.
Eagle first. You go to Tarakas. There is attack of opportunity from Zabinus right there.
Oh, really?
There's one right there. Yeah. Will change anything?
Yeah, you probably don't see it. I guess.
Oh, it's right here.
He's hiding out.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So the little guy, does it change your mind at all?
Mm.
It's kind of grasping at you, this little Sarlacc tentacle.
I'm gonna move over to Tarakas and then Wild Shape. So I'll take
it as Lilith?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Total is... Well, I don't have their up yet. Hold on. Six.
Oh. Take it. That's a miss.
So this tentacle slaps out at you. Lilith just bats it away with a sickle. What have you got in your hand right now?
Moonsickle.
Moonsickle. Yeah. Slash it away really quickly at the base, and you're able to get to Tarakas, wild shape into the eagle,
mm-hmm.
and then fly down.
Yep.
Okay. Lilith, Tarakas down into the hole.
Ah.
Good turn. Anything else? Sounds good.
Sounds
like a good turn to me.
Yeah.
The vines come back. Those vines. The vines turn. There's nothing for them to get at here. This vine's turn. There's also nothing for it to get at. The vine on the far side is going to slowly crawl.
It's going to fall down the hole.
It's okay. As far as it can to get towards Faygo. Oh, come on. It was so perfect. To get towards Faygo. But all it can do is use its movement to get closer. It's not going to make it anyway. To get close. It doesn't have very much movement. I'm such a good scene. I'm setting it back up again. Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't do it. Okay. The vines, not the most effectual. Tarakas, you are down, being held by this eagle. Anything you want to do while you're being held by this eagle?
Hold on tighter.
Okay, that's good. That's very smart.
And I want to ready in action.
Okay.
This is a spell slot. Yeah. Thanks for reminding me. Where's it at? There it is. We'll see what happens. So, I want to ready a Guiding Bolt for when Faygo makes his way down, if it happens in the next turn. And I can shoot it up to 128 feet away. So if I see him coming in, it would be better if I shot it at a distance.
You're gonna shoot me?
Yeah.
Fucker.
So tell me again, help me understand what's happening here.
I'm readying a Guiding Bolt to shoot Faygo on his way down if he proceeds to follow us. Because
okay.
I don't know how Faygo's getting down.
I'm gonna go down before you, probably.
Okay. So you're going to shoot him.
Yeah. As soon as I see him, pretty much. But we're ahead of him right now.
Okay. So as soon as he gets down there, you're going to... Yeah. As soon as you see him, you're going to shoot him.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
How far down the hole are you two?
This.
I'm
What's that?
Using how far down the hole
fifth
are you
level two? Spell slot, by the way.
Well, I had... How far did I have to move to get to Tarakas?
10 feet.
Okay, 10 feet. So then... I don't know how to figure out my movement. So I move 10 feet as Lilith, and then I can go 80 feet as an eagle.
So you would technically 2/3 your... You would have had 20 foot left. You would have 2/3 left as Lilith, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then you'd have 2/3 of your eagles left.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know what 2/3 of 80 fucking is, but... It's basically 55,
we'll
I don't know.
We'll give you 60 feet. We'll give you 60 feet. Make it easy.
Like, once she turns into a creature, she's like, okay, I know that.
Your percentage of movement.
It's all straight down the hole.
It's like 50 feet.
We'll say 50 then. So you have 50 feet down the hole?
Yeah.
And you...
I went 60.
Or 60 feet, so she's 10 feet below. Okay. All right. Held action?
Yeah.
Okay. Dusty, what's your plan?
30 feet
farther down the hole.
That should get me to 90.
Yep, it gets down to all the way down. You can see first. You haven't been here before. This is a strange room that is dimly lit with an ambient purple glow, with lots of bubbling and strange sounds. It looks like there's lots of strange terminals that you've never really seen before. Strange metallic cubes and lots of blinking lights. There are creatures that are floating in solutions. There are things on display around the room that you've never seen before. It's a very strange place. That is where you are.
Are there any enemies? Nobody's down there.
At the moment, you don't see anything that seems to be threatening you.
Cool. Hurry up!
Holding anything or waiting for anything?
She'll hold an action if anything down there with her attacks her.
Sure.
She's gonna punch the shit out
of
it.
It's dimly lit. Fists at the ready. See if anything plays any funny business. Off above, the Forest Guardian's turn. Forest Guardian is going to be most preoccupied with the thing right in front of it. It's still slashing at it. Two attacks. First is a 16, which automatically hits without any pluses. The second one is a 6, which is a, using his plus of 10, is a 16. So, sadly, for Gunk, both hit.
Jesus.
I think he's still alive, honestly.
Well,
not for long.
22 on the first hit,
poor
and 19 on the second hit. Fagin, you're the only one that sees it. And really, your tentacle is the one right next to it. This forest guardian takes one of its long tree-like limbs and is, during one of Gunk's war cries, just puts it straight down his throat, all the way through him, comes out the other side and has lifted him up, and then the vine just kind of swells and gets girthier until Gunk just pops like a mitten. And it's split in a couple different sides. It's a couple
like
different pieces.
He said it. That's right.
That is its two actions.
Okay.
Fago, you're the only one that hears this in your earpiece since you're the team leader. You just hear it says, you hear it, teammate down. The end of its turn, though, is it's going to use its action to do that. Movement-wise, it considers, it hesitates, it kind of like, almost loses its balance for a moment, but it stays put on the edge, perched on the ledge. Fago, brings us to
How
your turn.
How big is the hole compared to it?
It looks like it would barely accommodate it, but...
Okay.
Barely.
Okay, so I am going to just go ahead and dive down the hole.
Okay.
Now here's the deal,
How
though.
Far?
I know what.
Yeah,
It's a free fall.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
But before I hit, I want to use my action to cast Bigby's hand to catch myself.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
It does.
Okay.
I'm rectifying things in my head. Help me DM this here.
I
free falls are weird. They happen immediately, right?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, so however during the free fall.
That is how it is.
So you've prepared us like a Bigsby's hand, so you started to cast this as you fall, getting ready to fall. As you begin to fall,
he's gonna do something.
You come into sight range, and you are doing what?
Casting Guiding Bolt.
On?
There you go.
Okay, I wanna be douchey here for a second, though. You don't have dark vision. Are you?
No, I don't.
Okay. Just make sure.
You can't see very well, right?
Mm-hmm.
I
was wondering if he was gonna bring that up in expectation.
Well, what I'm doing is a little bit is like, so you fall in, right? You can see him still. Mm-hmm. He's at the top of the tunnel.
And I can fire 120 feet away.
That's and you're doing this right away?
As soon as I see him, I can come down the
tunnel. Well, you can see him already. Like, he's... Is he starting to come
He sees me start to move toward the...
Yeah, as he falls into the tunnel, you can already see him. You won't be able to see him for long, because he's about to be in darkness.
I'll shoot, yeah.
I was going to say, you don't get a choice. You've already stated your held action, I guess. You're right. I guess it's right.
It's not really a held action.
I shouldn't give him a chance to undo it. I guess.
Oh, his is a held action.
Yeah.
He can choose not to do it.
You can?
Yeah.
Okay, on held action?
It still uses the spell. But
okay.
He can choose not to have
That's
it
good
go
for
off.
Me to remember. Don't let me forget that, because I tend to like you. Like, all right, you said.
Yeah.
All right, so you can see him start to fall. You know that there's only maybe a millisecond before he falls into darkness with you, and you know that you
so
won't
you could
see
do
him
it
anymore.
With Regan, without disadvantage, what should I say?
With one dice.
Okay.
You can see my silhouette, basically,
yeah.
So you can still see me.
Only for a moment.
In a moment's all I need. Probably not going to hit. It's going to be 16.
Nope.
Yep.
One short.
Fago, you can see that all these spells just goes up towards, just past you, and it sort of fizzles on the side of this guardian.
Could I tell it was coming at me?
Roll me a,
I'm just curious.
Roll me an insight check.
Just curious.
Tarakas, roll me a deception check.
Okay. Can you see me deceiving you?
Well, I mean, you're just
I have dark vision.
Sort of a passive deception check, is I guess not really fair here. Let me roll for it.
12.
12?
17.
17?
You can tell me what I know or not.
Trox is a pretty good shot. And you've been on a lot of these missions. The spell hit the guardian, didn't really seem to do anything.
Mm.
Maybe, you can maybe infer that maybe he wasn't the intended target.
Got it.
Did it do anything?
Well, not on a miss. I'm not going to give you...
Dang it.
Sorry.
No collateral.
That was just like flavor.
Yeah.
I know.
That is a held action. So you're falling. So as you fall by him, you might hear Tarakas on the way by.
Ah, I'm still screaming.
Yeah. And the Bigsby's hand on the bottom catches you.
Just
trying to catch you and like slow your momentum. I don't see any reason why you can't.
It can definitely lift me. That's strength of 26.
Okay, so then you will. I want to see why I couldn't slow your momentum then too. Okay. Action. Baby's hand.
I guess
bonus.
Now that I'm on the ground, I'm going to move away from the whole area, if I can move away from the whole area.
You see Dusty down there as well, kind of looking around. You also haven't been here before. A lot of blinking lights, a lot of these strange terminals, and you notice the familiar thing from the briefing that is the hatch in the middle of the floor.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing where you're supposed to be placing a lot of these explosives in the lower level. Gunk. Oh, sorry.
Oh, no.
Lilith.
When I do land, I'll be like, by the way, Gunk's dead.
Oh. I'm going to continue flying down and put Tarakas down on the ground.
Okay, and Lilith in eagle form sets Tarakas on the ground.
We have a bird.
Gah! Staying in bird form?
Nice.
Yes.
Okay.
Nice.
Stand there. All right. That's the vines. Is there any vines up there? You've already dropped down. So I believe everyone's down in the hole now, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
All right, which will leave us out of initiative. And we will... Stop the sound for a minute. So, as everyone has dropped into this station, the apoptosis station, everyone is witnessing this low purple ambience, the blinking lights. Those of you that have been here before know what to expect, know where this is headed. You guys can see the hatch in the floor where you guys were, or Tarakas rather. Was there the first time, and you guys can see the familiar canisters and tanks that are housing and displaying all of the different horribly deadly pathogens, creatures, and instruments of destruction that are housed here in the Temple of Death. And that seems like a good place to go to break. Let's go to break. And we'll come back, see what happens here at the Temple of Death when we come back in about 5 minutes. In just a few. Welcome back. Welcome back. Before the break, the party had gotten through the haunted forest of Cadus Silvis, and arrived at the Temple of Death, the location of the Apoptosa Moire, this AI that had been worshipped for so long, and had managed to get there by only losing one of the party so far. Gunk, the albino alligator, was lost, and leaving only the four heroes of the Bravo team left. They arrived at the base, the lower floor, this strange station of futuristic technology. They arrived together, Lilith, Fago, Dusty, and Tarakas. So, the scene is this dim light, the blinking lights, and you guys have the mission parameters ahead of you to destroy the things in the lower hatch. Fago, you have most of the you have all of the explosives with you, on you, in you. What's everyone want to do?
I had a question.
You have a question?
Yes.
I have an answer.
Last time we dropped a blight in the vat. Do we notice anything different down here after doing that?
Now, which vat specifically did you guys put this into?
We put it in the one with the tree stuff, wasn't it? I think because we wanted it to like affect the forest.
The forest around it, yeah?
Yeah.
This vat has definitely filled up with this black ichor, this blight that you cast on it, right? The vat is no longer a functioning ecosystem. It is just filled with this black stuff. It's like a bad, like a bottle of kombucha that's gone bad. And there is edges where the vat has popped in little bits of black, but looks almost like bile, blight and bits of organic material just kind of like are dripping kind of out and onto the ground. There's this black blob that is, and you can see that like parts of it are on the floor actively still trying to leave. It's just like trying to crawl away.
Gross.
This blight and this organic material have sort of fused and are locomotive. It's moving away. Kind of just like trying to crawl away from the table. You can see there's just a line of it kind of going towards a little crack in the foundation of the station. It kind of just goes and seeps into the soil nearby. Whatever it is, it seems to have escaped the vat.
Oh, it's coming. Okay.
There's a lot of it left in there. It seems to have multiplied quite a bit. And Lilith, as you get close to it, a little bit of it actually like forms a small like pseudopod head and just kind of goes, mother? Kind of reaching at you. And then
I'm still an eagle though.
As quickly as it does, it just kind of like, it can't keep its form very long. It's like Sandman in the beginning of the movie. So like, mother?
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm not judging.
The eagle says caw.
I'm not judging.
The rest of the room, what else is the rest of the room? The vat of the girl, you guys recall. Mm-hmm. There is the empty vat that once held
Grung. Yeah.
Now
I
empty.
Had to let him out.
Yeah.
Among other things.
Enjoyed some talking time with him.
I know.
There were some other things you guys had also noticed, had also seen that were on display, like these canisters that are quite cold to the touch that had labels on them. Mm-hmm. Like septococcus, meningitis,
yeah.
And
influenza.
coronavirus,
bubonic plague.
That's what it was.
Lilith, you're kind of like hopping from foot to foot, and you kind of look at one of these canisters, and it just says H1N1.
No thanks.
Not an avian one, to be careful.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Right. So.
Yeah, I'm just going for the hatch. I'm working.
Fago's kind of slurping towards the hat.
Okay.
Fago.
I need to appeal to you here. I'm familiar with this place because it's tied to
my divine being that I get my power, so to speak. It's a place that's full of history, and we need to preserve it. If we don't preserve the history, it's just bound to repeat itself. And
if we don't blow it up, we blow up.
What if we didn't?
How would we not blow up? You probably have less than 6 seconds to do it, because the quicker we debate it, they're just going to fucking fuck us. They keep walking towards the hatch.
You got Tragus making the constitution saving throws. This familiar ring is in your head.
All right. They're just going to kill us. And then blow this place up anyway.
You're the only one having to make the save, though, because you're the only one really kind of posing this time. Everyone else is not really...
16? What was it, a con save?
Yeah. 19. Con save. A total of 19?
Yeah.
Okay. You feel this, like, ringing in your ear. It is getting stronger and stronger. With a 19, you're going to make your save. So let's see. Is there anything on a failed save? Or on a successful save? Hold on. It's opened up a new stat block.
What?
Yeah. There's not. So on a successful save, yeah, nothing happened. So you can hear that this ringing in your ears is getting louder. It isn't stopping either. But for the moment, this whatever it has activated doesn't seem to have had any effect on you. Lilith, mm-hmm. when he's doing this, you notice the same thing you noticed earlier. It is coming from the tunnel now this time. You see the same thing you saw
the
earlier,
tunnel?
But it's coming from above you in the tunnel.
Oh.
And he is, like, he is still headed towards the hatch, and you are kind of torn in between two places. You can still hear this thing in your ear. Yeah. It's now we're kind of in rounds, essentially.
Yeah, that's fine.
Actually, why don't we roll initiative?
How long has it been? Because Big B's would either be there or not be there.
That's fair, because I still have Sanctuary on me, unless it's been past a minute since we've...
How long are you gonna stop and smell the flowers? Probably not long.
I feel like I'm not at all.
Yeah, well, I think it's all charged, set up. So.
I'm going with Sego, like...
Let's roll initiative so everyone kind of knows where you guys are all standing, but I think it's pretty much immediate, so Big B's pan's probably still up.
Okay.
Although your Sanctuary is still up.
Like, I probably have a few seconds on it, because I'm less than that, but I'm...
Yeah.
Just initiative at least.
Not yet.
Right? That's why I was like,
so
that's very nice. Damn it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get a quick order here. 25-20?
21.
Ooh!
Oh, no!
2015.
I rolled nerds dice, that's why.
15-10.
13.
Let's go, you rolling.
11. And Tarakas, where are you at?
7.
Ooch.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nerds.
So Fago's making your movement towards the hatch, making your way downtown.
Yeah.
Now, it's a bigger room. It's a big station, so it probably is going to take your entire movement and action to get to the hatch.
Yeah.
But hatch is propped open as it was left last time, and the hatch is, so it's not an action to get down to. So you're just kind of like basically at the top of a stairwell. It is a metallic stair that, if you remember last time, Lilith was calling down to Tarakas. But Truck is the only one that has been down there. Fago, as you get closer to it, you can feel the temperature drop a good 20 degrees as you're at the top of this hatch.
I am, just for the record, like, I'm going to make sure that Big B's at the end of my turn is, because it has 60 foot of movement, which is basically the same as mine with blah, 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 is between me and him.
Okay, between you and Truckus?
Oh. Yeah.
Okay. Dusty, what are you doing in this, during all this?
I'm following Fago.
Okay.
Like, that's...
Keeping up with him, just right next to him?
I like my neck where it is, attached to my body. I am fond of both.
Yeah. See, she's a winner.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Who purposely loses.
Yeah. There's more money in that. Besides, the one time I didn't accidentally, I killed somebody. It was their fault. They're stupid. But whatever.
Cracks.
Okay, keeping up. Lilith? What are you doing in all this? You see what's happening? Just cawing, your eagle eyes kind of noticing some things, and cawing along. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, like, I feel like it's your rose. I really do, but...
Yeah. We'll feel this, and I'm going to fire. Once
on your
turn?
It turn, is your turn,
yeah.
You're
done, Lilith. I don't mean to mention it.
Boom.
Fago again, just because I know he's got buttons and stuff. And
he's got stuff inside of him?
Yeah.
Okay. Roll me a Fago.
Question, because I have, basically, I have full coverage from Big B's.
Yeah.
So are you shooting Big B's, or are you shooting...
Because you put it right between you and him.
Yeah, and it's a large creature.
It's a creature? It's not spectral? I thought
it was... It has an AC, it has health.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's different, so...
Okay.
Different,
yeah.
Big B's hand is different than...
I mean, it still looks like a tentacle.
It punches
but...
things.
Come on.
It has feelings.
It has feelings.
It has lots of hopes and dreams.
I wanted to go to college.
It files the taxes. Actually, I don't know that. I just wanted to
say. Like, it is translucent, so you can see through it.
Let's not go too far.
So, in at...
You'd have to move around it. You'd have to like move to like get around it or something like.
Like you'd know, you'd be able to see it. You can just see.
It's been placed. He's placed it right between the two of you, so you'd have to like, kind of move around. Yeah, it is your turn, so you have to. Like,
okay.
Get then around the movement and open up the angle.
Well, let's do that.
I'm not very good at theater of the mind. So yeah, you kind of move. You move into get around the cover he's put up. The Bigby's hand kind of moves as much as it can, but eventually you get a good angle on him.
Sure.
Fago is not surprised. I think he's been tipped off from earlier. So go ahead and roll. What you rolling again? What you rolling?
It's just a first level guiding bolt.
Okay.
And I miss.
First level guiding bolt.
Yep.
There's a. Are you sure? Okay. Oh,
I rolled
so
lower than I did last.
Oh time. No! I'm so yep. sad.
I keep rolling that die too.
The.
It's so pretty.
I know. Doesn't roll or shit though.
Anything else on your turn? Movement.
Bonus action?
Bonus actions are available as well.
Where's the bonus action? There we go. Fire that. I don't have a bonus action because I can't cast another spell. I'm done.
Okay. You could get out any things you might want as well on your turn. Top of the round is Fago. Fago, another shot across the bow. Obviously, this one's, again, obviously at you.
And warning, don't touch that hatch!
The hatch is open, right?
Hatch is open. Okay. Just kind of like, it's propped open. There's a set of stairs, a ladder that is,
So I'm going to crawl down the hatch.
Okay, just kind of squirming your way down.
You touched it.
Yep.
You did touch it.
And then I'm going to have Big B's shut the hatch and lay on it.
Okay. Because your bonus action to move it, right?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. This is started to lay down on top of it. Anything else in your turn?
I'll just radio up to camp and just be like, so ETA on a ship when we need it.
Response back is immediate and frustrating, as it says, extraction will be delivered as soon as the confirmation of the destruction of the target is confirmed.
So you're going to blow us up, Ben, because we're blowing up the underneath us?
If you're around the top of the on the top of the temple, we're ready for extract. If the bombs are set and timed and primed and confirmed, we're ready for dust off.
I'll tell you when they're set and how much time.
There's a pause and it says, no need, we'll know.
I would assume I couldn't start setting them when I'm down there, so.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Lilith.
Are you just kidding?
Nesty.
I did. Sorry, I already moved it. That's my favorite trick. The double initiative.
Sometimes we don't catch it.
Dusty.
So you went down the hole and you got Bigby's hand covering it?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Because I just don't want to fuck with him.
What?
You see, Tarakas looks...
Is your malfunction?
Are you kidding me? This is kind of what my life was picked for.
To be an asshole?
No, for this specific situation, to maybe die, I don't know.
So you want to be a stupid asshole? But that was...
It's not my fault you're uninformed.
Oh, I'm uninformed.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm uninformed?
Right.
How am I... Excuse me. I'm uninformed. Yeah. You're the one going around trying to kill us.
Well, not you.
And I'm uninformed.
Right.
You're a fucking moron. Oh. What is wrong with you? You do the job. You want to die?
Well, you know, I've been this
close sometimes.
The eagle
doesn't want to die.
Maybe it's just what's being asked for me. I guess, maybe.
The eagle doesn't want to die, right? She's gonna like saddle over to Tarakas' side and sit next to Tarakas. This
torn.
Isn't about side. Look, I don't want. Look, whatever. This is like some great fountain of knowledge. Whatever.
Yeah.
There's like 1,000 of those everywhere. Everybody says something to some sort of fountain of knowledge. It's stupid. Yeah. All right. I'm just saying. This is our job. We have to come in. You know, we're supposed to do this thing, and then we get to live. So, do you want to die?
Yeah. Well, I'm not doing this job.
Tarakas, why don't you make another con save? It's not even your turn, but we're talking a lot.
That's gonna be, a 17.
A 17?
Yeah, 17.
Very important. You get that right.
Yeah.
Because a 17 doesn't make it.
Okay, what
Sure, that makes you do math, right? Okay.
Sure, yeah. It's only a plus three.
That's why I was asking so much earlier when you're like, are you sure it's a 19? Because you're trying to be an 18, so I want to make really sure. All right, this is not great.
Please talk some sense into him.
As he's, let's see. Let me, I just don't like this. This auto roller again has rolled the same value again. But whatever. It's a, so, plus the dice is, so this is 22 psychic damage. Tarakas. Okay. To the inside of your brain.
It's a noodle.
As, again, this robotic voice that's coming through your ear just says, stay on program. And you're reminded of the mission at hand. The vibration in your ears doesn't stop, and it just says, this is your final warning. Lilith, your eagle eyes, now that you're standing right next to Tarakas, you see it clear as day. That same
thing.
Flash.
And it's still up above.
Mm-hmm.
In the tunnel.
You see where it was coming from. It's the same place where it was a moment ago. In the darkness. There's just a little...
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought.
And a little wisp of something going... Like it's familiar. Like you can kind of see the aurora borealis effects that are familiar to you. Of this little string of something. An effect of some kind. Tarakas. Technically... Oh, yes, no, I'm sorry. Lilith. It is your turn, as you're seeing these things. Mm. Sorry, you're up next.
I'm still holding an action.
Oh, yeah.
Something comes out and kind of tries to hit me.
If anyone's...
You.
I like the way you phrased that.
Yeah.
I don't think I need any clarifications. I actually think I know exactly what I need to know. Lilith, this little creature has balled up some fist and is looking like she's ready to fight anyone that looks aggressive towards her.
She's not, her fists are not balled up. She is just ready in case something hits her. She's small. And she's
if
fast.
Anything comes out of the thing and hits her. Okay.
She's worried.
Comes out of what thing?
Anywhere.
Anywhere. I think anything hits her.
Okay.
Period.
Okay.
If something tries to squash me.
Okay. And she's gonna change back into Lilith.
Okay.
Tarakas, oh, I know this is so hard, but
yeah.
We're gonna die if we don't do this.
Mm-hmm.
I know, it's important, and I don't want to destroy it either, but we have to.
They keep taking everything, Lilith.
I know.
All of it.
It'll always stay in your heart.
Bright guard.
It'll be right here.
No.
Yeah, no, I don't believe that either.
Okay.
But... I know it's really hard, but we have to do this. I mean, I know we have a choice, but the choice is death or destroy it.
And then live.
And I don't want you to die, Tarakas.
I mean, I don't want to die either.
I also do not want to die.
We know.
But you know, I just met you and I don't want you to die either.
That's very nice.
Just saying. I'm not a bad person. I just, you know, don't want to die in a hole. Here.
What if I paid you? You like to lose, right? What if I paid you? I don't know much about you. I'm sorry, guys.
Is this a real persuasion? Is this a real thing?
So... You're gonna pay me to lose, but losing is dying. So what the hell am I gonna do with any money that you have? You dumb shit.
I'm desperate, okay?
Just because I get paid to lose does not mean that I'm a fucking moron.
Well, yeah, you've probably got a bigger sight on the picture and all that, so
yeah,
okay, fine.
Yeah, I train those idiots. Is there any way you can, like, I don't know, like, download the information somehow and like keep it for yourself or something, and then we still blow it up, we just don't tell anybody?
I wish, but the person that has the cube that I was gonna do that with is not here.
Oh.
Which cube?
My Narita cube.
I don't have the Narita cube.
You don't have it.
No, you have
you
it.
You have it.
I thought you borrowed it.
Yeah, but I gave it back because
yeah,
I didn't want to fuck it up.
Yeah, specifically because you don't want to fuck it up. You're using the other cube.
Yeah, it was here.
So like rewind 5 seconds. Do you have a thing that could like, you know, download all the information and like, I don't know, save it somehow magically, but then we just don't tell anybody?
What, this thing, yeah.
Oh my gosh! Whoa. What is that magic cube thing? What will that do?
The THX sound plays. I don't have the rights to it. What's the power level at?
Inventory.
The last time you were here, you didn't have any power.
Yeah, exactly. So,
No power. What is it at now?
Zero. How is he alive? Do you just...
I protect him.
Okay. You really
have that. What level is that at? Narita was at zero in August.
Yeah. And never had recharge.
Yeah.
I successfully transferred some.
Wait. Yeah, you transferred 25% power from Apoptosa to Narita.
Yeah.
You've got 25% power.
When did this... Well, he messed with it after that, though. So
no, I didn't. Because
oh.
I didn't.
Let it happen. Just plug that baby into the side or something.
Let's default to the DM. I have Faradun at 73%.
Yep.
Apoptosa drained to zero because that's what he was using.
That's
right.
The thing.
Narita was given back power to 25%.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't remember that at all.
Yeah, that's and then I gave it to you because I figured out I could use the Apoptosa one.
I honestly thought I refused it because I didn't need it.
I have another note.
Yeah.
What's the other?
It's not in my inventory.
I have another note. You kept it at 25% so that he could have his god with him.
Yeah.
He used that last remainder of that 25%.
Yeah.
When did he do that?
To bring someone back from the dead.
Yep. Yeah.
Who was it?
It was
Azariah.
Thank you. Yeah.
No. That happened. No, Azariah
was long
ago.
Gone before I charged it back up.
Yeah, this was August. Like, this was like.
I don't have anything about it charging.
Yeah, I don't remember to charge.
Oh, you do? Oh my god, these notes. Guys, I gotta update this shit, so I'm gonna keep reading. I'm gonna keep reading. Because I look, Nerida.
Like, no,
it checks.
Yes!
It does. No, this does track. It's just, I have it chronologically. I need to delete things when they're... Nerida, keep it 25%. Now, dead after giving power to bring back Azariah. Faradun at 73%. Apoptosa, keep it 0%. 10% per attempt, but you drained it. Nerd now has functioning converter. Nerd used converter to convert 25% over to the Narita cube. I don't have a date on it, but it is the bottom. 10th. It is the last note that I have about the
cubes. And I gave it to him so he would have his god with him.
So I'm sorry, but let's do this.
She's got it.
You
right
have
okay,
a Narita
it.
Cube
yep.
That is dimly lit at 25%.
I'm rushing it over to a console whenever I can.
Okay.
Do it.
It's not my turn yet.
This console, if you recall, is had a...
Because there is one console upstairs.
There's one console upstairs where you had taken the Faradun cube.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So there's one console upstairs. You slamming this thing into it. There's a port. You guys know where these holes are at? There's like a port in it. You are presented with something similar to what the girl in Jurassic Park is looking at. And
I gotta find the right file.
Yeah.
I know this system.
I know this. You don't know this.
I expect I would.
But you definitely get what it's doing. It is segments of looks to be files, collections of digital scrolls that are categorized. You basically have an encyclopedia. Tarakas, what would you want to save from the entire sum of human knowledge if you could save a few things?
History.
Specifically, what kinds? It's not the knowledge of how to do things. It's the oral history of the people,
mm-hmm.
The oral history of the occurrences. Maybe not the how to do anything, but it is the story of the people. Yeah. I'd allow that.
I mean, I kind of have that down anyway from the quick May 12th. 2036, Dr. Tara Basu discovers and names object J487 Shiva and all that written down already.
So you're keeping the chronology of what you guys saw,
basically.
How
this world came to be, pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a good one.
Mm-hmm. You see that you're able to download the same archives that you basically witnessed to understand what had happened.
Mm-hmm.
And you see that this 25%, that's about full up. It's about all that it could maybe store at the moment. And you see all of the other files that you can't add to it, information about the scientific advancements, medicine, about space travel, about
get Shimmer files, man.
Oh,
and you see all these things
there, wouldn't it? Oh, damn.
That are no space for, but there's no more room.
Well, I've got regrets. Tarakus doesn't.
Tarakus, as you're doing this, I need one more constitution saving throw. Okay. Lilith, another glint as you see something reacting.
17.
17 is still that one below it. This is already set up to the right thing.
Right,
clicky
here.
Clicky click.
Yeah.
Oh god damn.
Yeah.
That's a almost max damage. 33 Jesus. Psychic. As this thing pops in your ear and it continues to ring. And as this
somebody answer that.
This in your voice you hear, Tarakus, I'm a fan. Please desist.
No.
That's right, you tell him.
Is anybody else doing anything on your turn? Because we're kind of out of combat. Is there anything else going to stop him?
I mean,
this is you're down below.
Setting up the things. How are you?
What are you doing during your turn? Let's do that right now.
Each turn that I get, I'm setting up
things?
However many of these things I can set,
yep.
or I'm supposed to set.
There are blinking pizza boxes
yeah.
that you're putting all these things on and setting a timer on, right? Lilith, you're standing up above. I'm just kind of witnessing everything.
Yeah.
You see Tarakus frantically watching this thing download this information. You hear Tarakus just say, it's kind of almost like he's speaking to himself. You just hear him say, no. And he pulls this thing off of the pedestal. Tarakus needs one final saving throw as you say no and deny these people. Before you roll, let me tell you the damage.
Well,
would people have time to heal in between the thing?
I said, can I heal?
No, I asked to what you're doing while you're up there. This is like he says, no pulls.
Well, I got an 18 on the die.
What?
I got an 18 on the die.
An 18?
Well, no, I'm sorry, not on the die. 18 total. Total. Okay. Yeah,
15 plus 3.
Yeah.
Just barely makes it. So you can hear this ringing in your ear. There's this, like, it is the highest frequency yet. It seems like whatever they've just flipped the dial to 10. And it's not stopping now either. So it's kind of agonizing. You can't, like, anything that you can see, Lilith, all you can kind of hear is this, like, whee!
Yeah. Ah!
So as Tarakus, as this is going, it's also not stopping in your ear. As you can imagine, like, when the next six seconds go by, it's going to happen again, and it's going to keep happening. Anything else? On your turn? Is anybody else doing anything?
I'm going to heal Tarakus.
Yeah.
Your turn?
Can I shoot?
Oh, I can hear the sound! Which one?
Can I stop her?
Death warriors.
From doing what she wants to do? You can do it. I mean, it's on your turn. She's gonna do what she wants to do on her turn.
That's fair. I don't know what she's doing. Yeah, I can't make it pick a different target or whatever.
So it just begins to start cycling up. I'll give you one turn.
I'm gonna cast.
Yes.
Cure wounds.
Oh,
yeah.
We did way before that.
I thought
at
you said
a fourth level. Not the best. That's gonna be 17 plus 5 is 22 health back.
22 health back.
Nothing.
So, anything else you're doing on your turn other than casting that? Hatch is still closed.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. I got my moonsickle. That gives me an extra d4 for heals.
Oh.
So add another 2.
Every little bit counts.
It does.
Oh shit, that was 22.
So it should be 24 total. Sorry.
Okay. Hey, Dusty, you want to get in on this at all? Or are you just kind of watching this happen, waiting for anything?
Healing? Or?
Oh, you're probably not. Barbarian's not really.
Oh, I mean, I would take it, but no. If they're doing their thing and, like, we've kind of come to, like, an agreement, she'll kind of, like, sidle up with them, just be like, so what are we doing? What's happening?
How many
I feel
rounds
like...
are best?
Technically 3. One talking, one doing this, and then one we're in.
And how many of these things do I need to set?
There's a lot. There's probably a half dozen of these things just setting them up. Probably like 1 or 2 more rounds. You're kind of setting these things up. Like maybe 12 more seconds of kind of running, setting them.
Okay.
Lilith, as you're healing Tarakas, this thing is still going off in your ear. I need one more constitution saving throw at the top of your turn, because this thing is still just, like, running now.
Let's go with this die. This one. There we go. That's another 15 on the die, so 18.
Another 15? So you meet it as another 18? Yep. So it's just kind of like, it's just kind of getting louder and louder. You almost can't hear anybody at this point. Fagel, you can hear in your ear. It says, another team member is... What would they say? It would give you an update. They'd be like, another team member is no longer active. You notice none of them have ever like really said which one it was. You didn't see which one it was.
Yeah.
This is all kind of happening up above. I'm assuming you're still setting things. You want to do anything else other than on your turn? You almost can't hear at this point. Is
that cube still loading? You know that?
It's loaded, and you've kind of like it's like you said no, and kind of like. Took it, so you kind of like are holding this cube. Okay. It didn't take any of the charge down, it's just at max capacity now.
Okay.
Max file size.
Well, I don't know what's gonna happen to me, so take this, because I can't hear anything right now, and it's so loud!
Shove it in her bag of holding.
Okay, shove it in the bag of holding. Fago, you're doing your thing, setting them.
Yeah.
On this turn, you're probably setting your last ones on this round. Dusty, still just kind of like watching this happen.
She'll kind of just slightly saddle closer to Lilith.
It's a scene. Tarakas says both of his ears are bleeding. Okay. If you guys remember, Tarakas' blood is not red. It's this like blue sparking liquid that's like coming out of his ears.
Maybe try breathing.
I'm breathing so hard.
Yeah, I know. I don't. Oh.
As this gets louder and louder, Lilith, it's your turn. Tarakas has handed you this device. He's put it in your bag, and you can see that his eyes are getting like.
Can I see the?
Glint starting to bulge still? Almost.
Can I fire at the glint?
Yeah, you can. Go ahead.
I wasn't sure if I could do that, and it just dawned on me. I'm like, wait a minute, hold on. I'm gonna cast blight at the glint up in the.
Okay, what's your range on that?
The range... Oh, that's only 30 feet. Sorry, not that one. That could be bad.
Ooh, I like it. I don't know what you're thinking, but I like the... I like it's bad.
Actually, no, that... Oh, that's gonna be so good. Okay, I'm casting Ice Storm.
It's a
300-foot range, but it is a... 20-foot radius, 40-foot high cylinder centered on a point within range.
So you're basically filling the cylinder with the
glint.
We're looking for like
in the tunnel.
The tunnel.
Filling the tunnel with a pillar of ice storm.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Is it a save?
It is. Each creature in the cylinder must make a dex save.
Okay.
Fails. So it's gonna be, let's see, creature takes 2d8 bludgeoning. Do you need bludgeoning and cold separate for any reason?
No.
Okay.
Dusty, what's Lilith doing?
You just see Lilith turn and just like cast a spell, and you just see the tunnel you guys just came from. Looks like a Final Fantasy movie is just... like sheets of ice and snow start to like come slamming into the ground from above.
Okay, it's not the best, but it's 21 damage.
You guys remember how much those drones had?
Nope.
20.
Oh!
Nice.
You guys see from the tunnel, as the ice storm ends, there's two froze small, like, again, this is not the right.
Yeah.
Up above. So, yes, Lilith, you can see like this cling! Cling!
Those land around us.
Two drones just
in
like
the call off.
Oh, okay.
Fall down below.
Okay.
They're frozen solid and sparking.
Did all that
down below.
Can openers?
Down below, Fago, you can hear another another teammate is on. And there's kind of nothing but like in your ear.
Wow, I set my last one, and I'm going to set them so they all have, like...
How long is your timer?
To me, I would set them all so when I set the last one, they'd all have a minute.
Okay, so like the 60 seconds and then tink, they all start to tick down.
Yeah, however that works, yeah.
Yeah, sure. Okay. They're all synchronized. We'll
okay,
that.
Perfect.
The last one set, the 60-second timer commences.
And I'll use my bonus action to have Bigby's hand open then.
Okay. On your turn.
Yeah. Let's haul ass, people!
You come up and you see Turok is sort of like almost like on his knees, but not technically prone. Kind of clutching his head.
Is he still loud?
There's these two drones that have fallen.
What the fuck?
In the tunnel. You guys, what do you want to do? As you guys all see Faygo step up.
Come on, Lizard Man, let's go!
Am I still recovering? Like, am I still hearing this?
You probably have a ringing in your ear. But it's seems to the pain has started to slowly subside for the moment.
Oh, well, it seemed to work, Lilith. Wow, where did you see those things?
I mean, there was this glinting up there. I wasn't sure what it was at first, and then it just kind of dawned on me. It's probably a drone. And I wanted to make it stop in your head.
I think it worked. Thanks.
This is great, but we need to get out of here, right?
Yeah. Are you done fucking trying to shoot me?
Well, I... Yeah, okay. Fine. But I'm not agreeing.
Go now. We have like 40 seconds left.
Okay,
I just
cool.
go to the thing and...
What, 40 seconds? Yep.
I don't know.
Yeah. What's going on?
You guys get to the bottom of the shaft. You guys can see that the bottom of the shaft, there's these two dead drones. You guys look up the shaft. There's this 90 feet straight up. As you can get to the bottom of the shaft, there's again more static. It sounds like there's broken garbled transmission trying to get through Faygo, but there seems to be nothing relaying it down below.
Yeah. That's fine. I'm casting Bigby's hand and...
Yeah. I'm a...
When does that need? Just kind of like words kind of coming through.
I'm going 60 feet up.
You're flying up?
Yep. I'm doing the thing and I'm going to grab Taracus.
While shaping?
Yeah.
Picking up Taracus? Okay. So you're carrying Taracus.
Right on my back if
but
you want.
You're while shaping as a bird?
Yes.
And Faygo?
Bigby's
handing is like slow. And what's the speed for that?
60 foot.
60 foot. Okay. So like everyone's kind
but
of
it can only go 60 foot around. I can't do like 260s.
Okay, so it's 60 feet. That's the same as you.
Mm-hmm.
Same as you. And you can fly a lot faster,
or
right?
80 feet.
You can go even.
I can go 80 as my action.
Okay.
Or as my movement. So I could go 160 technically.
Okay.
I can go 80 feet.
Man, this is a weird one. How do I do this? So, as that's related, what would they do? This is crazy. So you guys are you're the first ones out of the tunnel.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You're the first ones out of the tunnel. Taracus, this pain has started to subside. As you guys get out of the tunnel, it comes back full force.
No.
As you guys are now up above ground, this ring comes back full force. Yours is still going. I need another Constitution saving throw as you guys are coming up. Lilith, similar thing as he. Even in bird form, you can see that now that you know what to look for, Taracus starts to yell again, that this is kind of like, ah, or whatever his warble, whatever to call the sound that is Taracus is making. There are more glints around. You can see that there are more of these drones that you know what to look for now that you're up above. But Taracus seems to be in pain again quite a bit.
11. Nice training, does that help?
23 psychic damage. It seems to have hit Taracus again, like it's still happening. And you, even in your bird form, can kind of hear that like there's a slow cycling up that is also starting to hit you as this, whatever it is, seems to know that you have seems to have gone rogue. So I need a Constitution.
I'm trying to find the exit point.
As you're trying to, I need a Constitution.
You're helping him.
Yeah. And remember these drones are cameras. They also are recording and watching everything, so they know that you shot at it.
Oh, in the tunnel, yeah.
It knows
that I hit those.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah.
It's what's watching you. That's why like you're also guilty as well.
Damn it.
So I need a Constitution saving throw from you.
Okay. 17.
17. You're going to take the same thing. I'll re-roll it as well, so it's fair because it was a pretty big roll. That's not as bad as 18 psychic damage. You can see where these are coming from. There are four more of these glints that are all around. Now that you know what to look for, they're all trying to hide and be sneaky and, you know, stay at a distance and not be as flitty as they are in their natural, when they're being themselves in Farjuda, right? They're trying to be more natural and trying to hide out. But you can see that there are four of these drones hovering, watching, and trying to give these commands to the devices in your head. The rest of the group, as you guys are coming up on your next turn, well, first off, this is, I didn't give you a other than reaction. Is there anything you want to do on your turns as you guys are flying up?
I need to land.
So you're going
to
land on the edge of this, the edge of the...
on the opposite edge of where that tree thing was.
The guardian?
Yes.
It's still kind of like lumbering around, but it hasn't, it's not just waiting for you.
It was at the top.
It's not just waiting for you.
If it's not at the top anymore, then I'm just going to land at the top of the ziggurat.
Okay, landing at the top of the ziggurat, feeling this immense pressure in your ears. You can both see, I guess, well, you're being carried, right? You can definitely see there is, in the distance, some glowing blue, like six blooming glow discs that seem to be on the bottom of a airship that's like slowly coming in for a for an extraction. It's familiar Venkirkian Federation airship coming in quickly. But below you are the rest of the party. So the next round, what's everyone doing? How much movement can everyone do? You guys can get out during the next rounds.
Yeah.
So you guys can get out. You guys can get out. You guys aren't having the same ringing in your ears that the other two are. And as you come out, you can hear that in your ear, you're hearing now very clearly, extraction is coming in. Quick dust off in roughly 12 seconds. Be ready. And you can see it coming in the same trajectory where...
nose dive, 12 seconds.
That they're coming in.
Okay.
And they are... coming at high rate of speed, as the airship arrives, who is all jumping on?
I mean, I was gonna fly onto the ship.
Is it flying onto it, carrying trucks with it?
I'm on.
As the ship is landing, as you guys all jump on, it doesn't go anywhere. It holds off, and the two of you. No, nosedive, and Fago, you can hear in your ears, says, what would it say? Unauthorized presences noted. Please rid the airship of any unauthorized presence, and we will dust off.
I would like to send an Eldritch Blast bolt at both of them.
At where?
Because I get two bolts of Eldritch Blast. Yeah.
At the two of them?
And especially if they're by the door, because if it hits, it pushes them back.
Oh, no!
That's force.
Roll me some dice.
Okay.
TPK by the alt characters. No.
21 to hit Lilith.
21
bird.
Hits the bird.
Ooh, 15 damage.
Okay, so I revert to Lilith.
Back to Lilith.
And gets pushed back 10
feet. 10 feet. Oh, into the hole.
I don't know, where's the ship at?
And you are hovering at the top of the temple.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Tarakas first. Before we do anything else, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
The damage, I take 8 as an eagle, and then the 7
rolls over.
Okay, yep. That's what I thought.
24 to hit.
And it's,
yep. Ooh.
15.
So,
10 foot back.
Yep.
Fago, they need. And it's okay. So Fago fires two Eldritch Blasts at the two of them, hitting both of them, knocking them both back 10 feet, and into the darkness. Dexterity saving throws for force movement. It's pretty tough as you're being forced back 10 feet.
Well,
this is not just like being slipping off. So this is a pretty this is pretty high DC.
12.
Both 12.
Yep.
You guys are kind of like clawing at the edge of the clawing for the edge of the airship, but with 10 feet of forced movement, you guys are both blasted off. And there's a moment you guys can just see Fago and this like little flying pixie, like a pseudopod that has enough appendages to flip you off, and a pixie that's sort of just kind of like.
What the fuck just happened?
What happened? As you guys are both flying backwards into the darkness, into this tunnel, as the airship begins to, you can hear like, begins to ascend. falling into the darkness. Taracus.
I love the fact that you both have.
This happens.
Death word.
This happens immediately. Taracus, you fall into the darkness. There's a. Lilith, you're also falling.
Mm-hmm.
You have a couple things you might be able to do during the. Oh, you're out. So there's two, like. You guys are both falling. But as you guys are falling, you guys can see this airship taking off. As you guys are beginning to fall, there's a perfect timing. Sometimes things happen for a reason. You can't kill something that's already dead. And as you guys are falling, the explosion happens at the exact same time, ripping through this facility, and there's a mushroom cloud that reduces everything inside of it, and this tunnel begins to collapse. Lilith, Taracus, both caught in this rubble, caught in this explosion, are killed at the same moment, tried to be killed at the same moment, three different ways. Through impact, through falling, through explosion, through the C4 explosives, and through the signal that is now being communicated to these devices in their brains. So at the same time, there's each of their eyeballs go get really big at the same time that they're falling and being incinerated. But the sum total of all of these things happening at the same time is that they're all reduced to zero hit points and then some. But welcome to 5th edition, but there's no negative hit points. Then you don't add them up the same way that you do in there's no like half your value. So you're reduced to zero hit points. However, Taracus has cast Death Ward, and the two of you cough and splutter in the dust nearby, blind in one eye each, as the one eye is still definitely mangled and horribly disfigured. Blind at one hit point, right? Is that how that works?
Yeah,
you reach one hit point.
Yeah.
Buried in rubble. But you can feel just at the edges of each other's fingertips a familiar companion.
Oh, it worked.
And I think that's a good place to pick up next time.
Oh, God.
So let's go to the metagame, because I need a second to process what just happened. Come on, let's go. Let's go to the metagame.
Oh, jeez.
You're in the metagame. Stay on metagame. Let's see. Well, we gotta wait for it. There we go. Now we're in the metagame. Welcome. This is a weird one. This is a weird one. Let's see.
Fago.
You shot at me first, you motherfucker!
No, I don't deserve it. I don't deserve it at all.
Everybody, don't PvP at home. We're professionals and we're trained.
I will say this. The player at the table in me, who's a part of your team,
right.
Yeah.
Was like, oh my god, yes, kill Fago. Oh my god, yes, do these things, do these things. But then I was also like, this doesn't make sense.
Yeah, I saw a world in which I was like, man, I wish Taracus had been given one of Nerd's guns, so he had a way of
I had one. Well, I picked one up from the last thing, but
shoot one of the bombs that's in him. You know, have it go off or something like that. Like I saw when you did Death Ward, I thought you were gonna while everyone's going in, be like, all right, cast Death Ward. Everyone get together, ready? And just kill everybody. And you'd be like, and then you guys would just stand up and be like, well, okay.
I wanted to do that. I had nothing to do that with.
I know, that's tough.
And I had nothing in my inventory to really do that with. The gun thing with his explosives on the inside, that's ingenious. I forgot that he stored everything inside of him. I wouldn't even know to do that, but...
It's D&D, you know? If it's not that, it's some other thing. It's just... I love the Death Ward idea.
It was a good
idea. When you did that and you did it to just you two, I was like... So how do I make rocks fall, everyone dies a thing? Because that solves everything for this Suicide Squad mission.
I do have a super meta question.
Yeah, do it. There's plenty of things
so
that I didn't like.
So now that the implant is not in their head.
Yeah, it blew up.
And they're not in the facility.
Yeah.
Nerd's whisper
message.
They're
free.
Oh, shit.
Would have reached her.
Oh, my gosh.
when he was like saying like bye.
But this is days and days later. Remember, like
no, it's not because I'm days ahead of you guys, right?
But that was the last of the 77th. We're right. on the 80th.
We're on your way.
Past, oh, I didn't realize we jumped ahead. Okay.
Yeah, gotcha, we jumped ahead twice because remember, like it wasn't immediate. You guys like said yes. You guys were in confinement for a couple more. I think it was like multiple days, and then went on your assignment. Okay. Took a couple days to get there. Went back, and you took a couple more days to get to this assignment. Now you're on. But you're half right. It's not that the old one gets through.
Got
it's that now, but you're right that now they are essentially free. There's nothing in their brains. There's no more drones. The Federation thinks they're dead, so they are effectively free now. But you're right. It's when is it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What day? Do we know what day it is?
Not at the moment.
Oh, fuck.
You know that's around. You think I have? If you had a guess, it's probably somewhere in the late 80s.
Yeah, because the last she knew was the 80th. So it's somewhere.
Just because I don't want to like meta this too much when we come back, it's the 86.
I remember it.
It's the 86. Okay. When
we come back, okay. I'm gonna make a note right now so I don't forget. But it is the 86. And it didn't because I ran out of time because I wanted to end there. But we'll pick up next time. I have a couple scenes with Nira that I want to get to, but it's good. It was a good place to end. But so when we come back next time, it'll be back to the OG crew basically. Faygo and Nosedive
in prison.
Are out. Kaz is still trapped in prison. Well, that's true, but Kaz is still is where he is.
When we separate the party, we really separate the
party. Party is separated.
Yeah. It's great.
So let's see. Let's do the...
Do like that in my character, I'm like, what the fuck? Everybody falls down like, what the hell just happened?
What did I get into? This team is a joke. How's everyone feeling? You blew up all your stuff.
Drained.
You had... a pretty good speech that I need to go back and clip.
My intention going in here was to either die right away and show them, hey, look, I can do this to everybody if it happened. Yeah. I completely forgot about that cube. And I thought the kill switch was more instantaneous instead of just dealing damage and then it finally kills you when you're out of hit points or something. I wasn't sure.
I think they can dial it up high enough that it would do
instantaneous.
Instant.
Yep. I think those were my like interpretation. Warnings.
It's literally there's a level 1 through 5. It's literally a number of d10 that I'm rolling.
Okay, but not knowing how that worked and then forgetting how the god cube on me, that would have been great if I just had
well,
in mind
going
there.
Well, now it's on
there.
Me.
I know. That's right. Yes.
We played 92 episodes. It's tough to remember every single legit flip.
I didn't need it anyway.
And
so.
You did. To be fair, you did try to refuse it when I gave it to you too.
Oh, okay. I forgot about that.
Why? Yeah.
Because he was like, "It's not really my god."
I don't need it anymore.
And I was like, "Nope, I'm still giving it to you."
Yeah. It's not my god either, so it's yours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was great. So we destroyed the archives, but you kept the history, the oral history of basically how we got here.
I saved a human race.
Yeah. That's big.
Not really.
But you had a really good monologue of a little bit like, no more. Like, they've taken it all and no more. It was kind of defeated.
Well, that's kind of, well, I mean, when he heard that it was, like, he was thinking, well, Kaz is, well, I don't know where. Nerd is, well, who knows where? Maybe dead. And, you know, just, he reached the end of his rope of how much he could take, pretty much.
I like that.
That's why I was acting so irrationally and just like, no, this is happening now.
How are you acting irrationally at all?
Well, for Tarakas anyway, you know, just he would normally try to play along and just get through it. But
hot-headed and like, nope.
Yeah.
I've made my peace. We're doing what
I was. I was like,
no more getting bossed around.
Yeah.
That was great. Well, let's do a couple of these questions. What about the collateral damage of the week?
My eyeball.
Your eyeball.
Not your both. My eyeball.
My eyeball. Lilith was so pretty, and now she has no eyeball.
You'll
it's
learn.
Just, it's in there. It's just like popped and big and white. You know, cloudy. You know, like what's the movie? Is that Mission Impossible that someone's just like?
Oh yeah.
It's a little thing that just pops, but it doesn't blow their head up.
Yeah.
Like a melon. It's just like. Yeah, you can see that like it's just made their brain mush. And
yeah.
The eye gets really big and off to the side.
It's one of those. Yeah.
And maybe the planet, because I feel like we probably released pathogens.
Ooh.
Oh my god.
Well, wouldn't the explosion incinerate all that?
I don't know.
That's
my question.
Thing, that's wondering if it survived.
I don't know about
it
all.
It could survive that. Some of it might have survived.
Who knows?
I don't know.
It survived that one already, so.
Like, lots of things survive and mutate.
The villagers are out of smallpox when you guys get out of rubble.
Somewhere there's a...
Yeah, they're all transformed into lizard people from
on a on a planning board somewhere, there's a little card that says My Cynthia that's just getting crumpled up.
Away. She's still alive somewhere.
Maybe.
Unless she was in Deep Crest.
We don't know what she was infected with either.
Yeah.
She wasn't in there.
We took her to the guy, right?
Yeah, we took
My Cynthia out.
Our mission to get to the...
She's alive somewhere.
Well, I forgot. It's not My Cynthia that's in the tube because you guys got her out.
There was her...
It's her classmate.
Yeah, it's her classmate.
It's the big one for the classmate.
Oh.
The one that didn't have a rich daddy. And you guys are like, that was a bounty for her.
She's like, I have a friend, but like, it doesn't matter.
Oh my God. I forgot I did that. That was just pettiness by the DM, but I did do that.
Sometimes you just don't want a fucking character to be like, I don't want to worry about this anymore.
No, they're...
Die.
Yeah. They don't have a rich patron. They're gone.
Yeah, that's the whole reason we got the fucking...
I forgot about that.
Yeah, that's right.
Baron Tavis. Oh God. Let's see. So what's next for the heroes? It sounds like Lilith and Tarak is probably a good place to start next time.
Oh, get out of the rubble.
Well,
one hit point.
In case things went south, I did prepare a 6th level spell. That would help us.
Okay, oh, but yeah? I used my 6th level spell to get here.
What is it?
Thank you. Planar Ally.
What does that do?
It's up to the DM, actually.
Oh.
What does it do?
Read the spell.
I'm curious.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
Wait, I don't have to pull up.
Just kidding, I made it up right now.
It's not real. You call out... No, it's not it. It's Mass Healing Word. This one's a very long-winded spell, but it takes 10 minutes to cast.
You got time.
So, you beseech an otherworldly entity for aid. The being must be known to you, a god, a primordial,
mm-hmm.
A demon, prince, or some other being of cosmic power. That entity sends a celestial, an elemental, or a fiend loyal to aid it, or to aid you, to make the creature appear in an unoccupied space within range. My idea was to call back your entity.
Which entity? Like my staff?
Yeah. Because that's a cosmic sentient being of which they didn't know that there were 3 of, I guess, mm-hmm. and that got split, so I'm trying to call something of that nature back to help us, to aid us. That was what my next move was going to be.
Oh, boy.
Spoiler.
How long does it stay there?
Until we're helped. But that also depends on the price of gold. Because if it happens within moments...
You live to pay it.
Yes, mm-hmm. yeah.
A fee.
Yeah. It's like 100 gold if it's like a minute of action that it has to do. If it takes days, it's thousands of gold.
1,000 gold per hour? 10,000 gold per day?
10,000, yeah, that's what it was. I don't know.
If the task is aligned with the creature's ethos, a payment may be halved or even waived.
Oh.
So I was hoping to call that back.
That's an interesting twist.
Have you get some sort of vibe off it and then ask a favor of it. Possibly. But that's what I had in my mind.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Gotta remind that staff how good of friends you were.
We were such good friends. We had such good times.
But I knew it was of something of great power. I mean, because people were fighting over it, and you know these AIs were built and all that. So I don't know, not from it, obviously, but yeah.
Lots of things want it.
Yeah.
I mean, you also know a pump dose of it. You also know Narita.
Yeah, but I don't want to touch any of that stuff. It seems dirty.
Seems none.
Well, I mean, everybody's able to perverse it, you know.
Sure. So. Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll pick up with Nerd and Lilith and Tarakas, and also Kaz next time.
Okay.
So join us, won't you? We'll see what happens. I don't know if everyone get back together, but we'll do our best to try, okay?
Sorry.
But tune in to see if it happens, all right?
Character made it out.
See y'all.
Bye!